The following is a production of Hometown and Home Country Radio Sports.
We've never seen a team like this before, ladies and gentlemen. After all this time, Bishop Garrigan is still golden. Bishop Garrigan has finally slain the Newell Fonda Dragon. Your Golden Bears are state champions for the second year in a row.
This place is packed, and it is going to be rocking in here tonight. Crooks tapped it backwards, and we are underway. Buckle your seatbelts, everyone. In the lane, Crooks, center of the paint. Oh, a nice spin move, and she lays it in.
Oh, with her left hand, she claps the hands and says, let's go. You got to feed Audie this last 2 minutes.
Three-pointer is blocked at the buzzer, and that's it. After coming so close the past 2 years, Bishop Garrigan has finally won it all.
Video streaming on the Algona Radio YouTube channel is brought to you by Kemna Auto Center. It's not just about the car, it's about the care. Algona Municipal Utilities, community owned for community benefit. Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona. Iowa State Bank, helping people succeed. Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident. PMC Advantage Insurance, having the advantage makes all the difference. Now, here's Sports Director Tyler Lance.
Live from Bishop Garrigan High School, it's Top of Iowa West Basketball on Hometown Radio KLGA. As two Top of Iowa West rivals go at it tonight, it's the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears hosting the North Union Warriors in a battle of two state-ranked teams. Golden Bears coming in 17-1 on the season and a perfect 12-0 in Top of Iowa West play after defeating Belmont Clemmie last night 66-45 and picking up their 68th straight conference win. Meanwhile, North Union's on a roll as well. They've won eight consecutive games and they've moved up to the number 13 spot in the Class 2A rankings. Warriors come in at 13-4. They are 10-2 in conference play, and they have not lost since the month of December. In fact, in that stretch, a win over Forest City, as both the Warriors and the Indians now two games behind Bishop Garrigan in the loss column of the conference. So if North Union can win tonight, they can really open up that Top of Iowa West race and make things interesting coming down the stretch. It's the Golden Bears and the Warriors coming up in just a couple of minutes, but first, we'll hear from both head coaches, starting off with North Union head coach Merle Tagus, followed by Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwab. They're both coming up on KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube channel.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folt, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 agency. A fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
PMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
High school basketball action right now on Hometown Radio KLGA's. The North Union Warriors visit the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, and right now we're joined by North Union head coach Merle Tagus. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time today on the pregame show. Let's start off by recapping what's been a busy week so far for the Warriors. You guys had wins against North Iowa and Belmont Clemmie earlier this week, so just give me a little overview of both those games and how you felt the team came out in the win in those.
Well, just a lot of it's just been just happy with our shot selection. That's a lot of it, just taking good shots and trying to find shots that work for us, and they did a good job last couple games, and both teams, they both run a nice zone defense, and we just tried to find holes in their defense some and take advantage of it, and the girls did a nice job.
And coach, right now, team, currently on an 8-game winning streak. When you look back at this streak, what specific aspects do you feel have improved with the team or matured maybe since their last loss this season?
Oh, just keep working through the things that work for us. You know, each girl has their individual talents, and just trying to find them to put them in the best spots to be successful. And we've got some wins lately, which has been nice, obviously. And just nice to be trying to compete with everybody the best we can. And overall, the girls have been playing a little better. So overall, it's just been a good streak.
And coach, tonight, Top of Iowa West play continues as you guys visit the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, facing them for the second time this season. What are a couple of the big adjustments you want to make from that first matchup that went Bishop Garrigan's way?
Oh, they're just a very talented team. You got to do a good job of dealing with all the pressure they put on you, and they did a nice job. They do a nice job putting pressure on teams, and we just got to handle it better. Hopefully we can. And, you know, it's just one of those deals. Hopefully as the season goes on, you make some of those adjustments. And just, and again, they're a talented team, so you do the best you can.
Talking right now with Norfolk Union head coach Merle Tagus. Coach, what would you say one or two of the biggest areas of emphasis for your girls are tonight?
I don't think you want to give any good team second opportunities. So hopefully we can do a good job on the boards. You know, that's important just to, you know, if they don't happen to make that shot, we want to try to keep them off the boards. And like I said, they do a good job putting pressure on the ball. Just want to handle the ball the best you can and, you know, not have a ton of turnovers. You're going to have some, obviously, but if we can do a little better job, that helps some anyway. And, you know, just overall, just do a better job in general.
Coach, as we wrap up, obviously with the postseason coming up early in February, one would imagine the postseason pairings are going to be coming out soon, and just a couple weeks left in the regular season overall for the team. So when you look at the next couple weeks of basketball action, what do you need to see from this group to say, we're kind of in playoff mode right now, or we're just about ready for the playoffs?
Well, I just want to keep making progress. You know, we've had a lot of young girls playing this year, and I just want to make sure they're just continue to improve. And, you know, the seniors, they're wrapping up their career. We want them to just stay enjoying their what time that's left and keep locked in and just, and again, do the best job they can too. They're wrapping up, you know, a lot of them playing for the last 4 years, and you want them to finish on a positive note, so that's what we'll try to do.
Well, Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck with tonight's game.
Yeah, thank you.
That is Norfolk Union head coach Merle Tagus with his pregame thoughts. Right now, quick timeout, but more pregame coverage coming up next on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you got to go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions. Satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op. Delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
High school basketball coming up here on Hometown Radio KLGA as the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears host the North Union Warriors. And right now we're joined by Golden Bear head coach Brandon Schwab. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time here on the pregame show. Let's just start by recapping the week up to this point because it's been a busy week for the Bears. Tuesday at Garner-Hafel Ventura, Thursday at Belmont Clemmy. So just kind of give me your thoughts of this week overall and how it's gone for the team.
Well, we're 2-0, and that's the main thought is we're 2-0 this week and hoping to get to 3-0 this week. And you know, Tuesday we didn't play our best basketball. We were a little shorthanded with you know, Zoe Montag being a little labored with an ankle, and you know, she's back now. We didn't shoot it terribly well on Tuesday night, but you know, bounced back last night, and you know, all we care about is wins right now, and making sure that we're playing good enough basketball to get that next win.
And coach, in a season that's had a lot of good wins so far, one of the better ones came back in December as you guys beat North Union 65-30 at their place. That was back on December 15th. Is there any part of that formula that you're really focusing on replicating for tonight's game?
Well, yeah, obviously if we could replicate how well we played at North Union, that would be really nice for tonight. But, you know, North Union is a much improved basketball team. I mean, as are we. From that time, but you know, we played really well in Armstrong that night, and you know, we know coming into tonight that it's not going to be that easy. I mean, they're going to come in, they know their backs are against the wall, and they have to win to have a opportunity for a conference championship. They know they've got to win, so we're going to get their best tonight. We're going to get their best effort, and we know with a few games left in the conference schedule that, you know, we've got a two-game lead, and the only way to finish this out for a conference championship is win. And it's on our home court, and I like the way we play at home. But, I mean, we're fully expecting a good game tonight. We're fully expecting North Union to make good adjustments and play us tougher than they did at Armstrong.
And coaches of the North Union team, like you said, they've really made some improvements since the last time around. They've won 8 games in a row. One of those was against a Forest City team that's also among the top teams in the conference at the moment. What do you feel some of those improvements that North Union has made since the last time you saw them are?
Well, I think they're rebounding a little better. I think they're shooting the ball a little better. And Merrill's finishing around the rim. She's developed some moves underneath the basket. You know, she's going to her up and under quite a bit. And I just think they're overall team-wise just playing better than they were early in the season. And, you know, that's a credit to Coach Tigges and their program that, they just keep getting better every time out. So, yeah, I mean, just I would say the rebounding and just, their shooting and stuff has just improved from early on in the season.
Coach, as we wind it down, what are one or two of the biggest areas of focus you have for your girls for tonight's game?
Just defensive intensity for the entire game and rebounding. You know, I mean, we kind of beat them up on the glass the last time we played them and got a lot of second chances. And I still think that is an area that we're better than them at is on the boards. And, I hope we can control the boards and get them go one and done and make things tough on their guards. Their guards have been very good lately, and so are our guards, and we hope to make things a little tough on them tonight.
Well, Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck with tonight's game.
All right, thank you.
That is Bishop Garrigan, Golden Bear basketball coach Brandon Schwamm of his thoughts on Hometown Radio KLGA. Right now, we'll step aside for a timeout, get you closer to tip-off between the North Union Warriors and the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears coming up on Hometown Radio.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions. Satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op. Delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for healthcare.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Herpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Herpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen, when you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of 9 physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Phil's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
It's time to meet the starting lineup for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears.
Zoe Montag, junior, number 22.
Garrigan of the steal. Here comes the transition. A sidestep by Montag in the lay-in. Zoe Montag is going crazy right now, and Garrigan's up 81-38.
Emmy Bartolo, sophomore, number 10.
Cross-court feed over to Bartolo. Catches, fires, rattles in a three-pointer.
Tayshia Olish, sophomore, number 24.
Tayshia hangs and passes to the left wing. Olish, three try, and she swished it again. Let Tayshia Olish shoot it.
Gracelyn Eastman, freshman, number 15.
Kicks it out Eastman. Eastman a tray. Eastman knocks it down. First career three-pointer.
Abby Capacious, senior, number 21.
Capacious weaves around traffic, puts it up. She put it in the foul. Abby Capacious with a chance for a three-point play.
Tip-off of your game is coming up next on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Welcome inside Bishop Garrigan High School, where tonight it's a top of Iowa West battle between the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears and the North Union Warriors. That was the Golden Bear lineup you just heard for North Union and head coach Merle Tagus. They have the 5'5 freshman Ainsley Ulrich, the 5'7 senior Libby Stevens, the 6' junior Ava Steinberger, the 5'11 senior Olivia Merrill, and the 5'7 senior Naomi Jones. Golden Bears in the home whites tonight. The black BGHS across the front outlined in yellow and the black trim down the side of the uniforms. North Union in the road greens with the Warrior logo on the front, white numerals on the front and back of the jersey. Warriors number 13 in Class 2A. They are 13-4 overall in the season. Bishop Garrigan number 6 in Class 1A, 17-1. One of those wins was a 65-30 win earlier this season at North Union High School. But tonight, it's a fresh start for a Warriors team that's won 8 games in a row, including beating 4th City not that long ago. At midcourt, Abby Capace for Bishop Garrigan, Olivia Merrill for North Union. Ball's in the air. Merrill wins the tap, and she bats backwards to Stevens as we are underway. North Union heads right to left on the radio dial, and we are rolling. Warrior offense, 4 from the top of Iowa West at 45.5 points per game as Jones cuts baseline, and it'll be a turnover early for North Union.
9 seconds into the game, already a stoppage. Boy, turnover is going to be a key here, Tyler. Both teams, very good ball handlers. Whoever can take the ball, take care of the ball the best, is going to get out to that early lead.
Bishop Garrigan leading the conference in offense, 65.4 points per game. North Union letting up 45.2 as Capacious in the high post. Deals right to Montag. Catches, fires, missed the three-pointer long, and snatching the rebound to Stevens, playing with that right shoulder wrapped up. Stevens brings the ball into the front court, dribbles with the left hand, picks up her dribble, and passes left corner to Jones. Jones heads right around the perimeter. The first team all-conference selection from last year hands the ball off to Stevens. Stevens near the top of the key goes around the Merrill screen, sidesteps towards the right, finds herself for a jumper, and it's tipped by Eastman. Merrill collects the ball in the lane, Montag trying to rip at it, and a jump ball is forced, possession towards Garrigan.
Well, Stevens, very good offensive player, always looking for her shot. Eastman was not guarding her, but she came out from the middle of the lane and helped out on that shot, was able to get her long arm extended and tip that shot.
Warriors play 2-3 zone on defense coming out as Olish has the ball left wing. Capacious at the left elbow. Passes right side to Montag. Finds Eastman inside. Passes a little high, though, and out of bounds. Merrill's playing behind Eastman defensively that time, and the pass just a little bit too tall for the Garrigan freshman.
Garrigan trying to run that offensive set where they look for Eastman on the lob. Zoe Montag throws a nice lob pass, but a little too tall. Montag coming off an ankle injury, starting for the first time in a couple games.
Golden Bears back on defense. They're number two in the conference defensively, allowing just over 38 points per game as Jones has the ball on the right wing. Feeds Merrill on the post. Goes to work against Eastman. Pivots, tries to go up and under. Bangs it up and in. Unlike the Merrill for a flurry of moves, and it's 2-0 North Union.
Yeah, that was a great old-school move by Merrill, the old up and under. She crossed over, went back the other direction. Nice job working on that move this season.
Capacious high post. Floored over Merrill, and she banks it in, tying the game at two.
Another classic basketball. Using that glass, Tyler. You don't see people use the glass like they're supposed to.
Well, Abby Capacious does, and she's on the scoreboard. That'll be interesting to watch offensively tonight. Capacious had 22 points against North Union last time around as the bounce pass knocked away by Aulish. Aulish picks it up and runs the floor. Drifts towards the far side of the court. Deals outside to Bartolo deep on the wing. Now Aulish left corner. Left open for three. Aulish off the front of the cup, no good. Capacious rebound. Tries to put it back, and she does. 4-2 Garrigan. And Capacious is her first cleanup of the night.
Well, you've said Capacious rebound about 8,000 times this season. She's a leading rebounder on the team. And boy, does she really battle for the boards.
Capacious, 10.2 rebounds per game, had 22 points, 14 boards against North Union back in December. Right of the lane, Ulrich spun it up and in with crazy English to tie the game at four.
Oh, there is that English that you like so much, Tyler. I don't know how that ball got up over the rim. That spin on that ball just carried it against the laws of physics up over the top. Great shot by Ulrich.
Capacious in the high post, gets it right side to Montag. There's going to be a lot of high post touches for Capacious tonight, and Garrigan's going to make North Union either bring Merrill out or have her wait back and let Capacious shoot the floater. That's going to be the predicament that North Union has to deal with defensively when Capacious gets those foul line touches. Montag right side, flings it across to Aulish on the left wing, 8 on the shot clock. Capacious foul line, Capacious floater, puts it up, it rolls in and the foul! Abby Capacious again, and Garrigan's up by two.
Wow, another nice shot by Capacious. She's getting that ball at the high post, and once she gets it there, she can either shoot, drive, or pass to Eastman down low, and they're really forcing the North Union defense to make an adjustment there.
Abby Capacious, the two-time second-team top of Iowa West selection, an 80% free-throw shooter, drills it. Abby Capacious, 7, North Union, 4, at the 5:21 mark of quarter number one. In the backcourt, it's Stevens bringing it across the timeline for North Union. Stevens herself was a second-team all-conference selection last year. She'll head left around the perimeter. Gives it off to Jones. Capacious guards Jones. The screen by Merrill. Capacious stays with Jones around the right side of the perimeter as Ulrich now has it on the right wing. Ulrich to the baseline. Capacious switches off onto her. Ulrich picking up her dribble and traveling.
What a really intense defense by Garrigan. They started out in a press. They showed press, and then they immediately backed off as soon as Stevens had the ball, showing some respect to Stevens' ball handling abilities. They just went back, got in their 2-3, and decided to force that turnover with a pressure.
These two teams right now have the two longest win streaks in the conference. Garrigan has won 13 games in a row. North Union has 8 in a row. Capacious ducks under Merrill. Deals into the corner to Montag. Her pass towards Bartolo sails into the backcourt and out of bounds. Way too tall that time for Emmy Bartolo, and that'll be a turnover.
So, the officials are going to say, did someone touch? Oh, they did, yes. I'm sorry. North Union is going to get the ball right on the sideline nearest their hoop.
Aulish guards the inbound pass, bounce pass towards Jones, left corner for North Union. Comes back out to the senior Stevens. Stevens driving right side. Stevens picks up a dribble and flings it into the corner to Steinberger. Back to Stevens along the perimeter at the 4:36 mark of quarter number one. 7-4 Garrigan. Back to Steinberger right side. Back out top to Stevens. 4.5 minutes left in the quarter as Stevens heads around Aulish, and Aulish blocks that time and committed the foul.
So Garrigan defense, you know, they'll switch back and forth between man and the 2-3, but right now they're on man-to-man on this out-of-bounds play, but they've been switching back and forth a lot this season.
Stevens from the left side baseline looks and gets it into Ulrich. Fresh 35 for North Union as Ulrich penetrates into the lane, bounce pass, attempt, and she traveled. Ainsley Ulrich with a couple early travels and turnovers for North Union.
Yeah, 2 turnovers in a row for North Union. That will make Coach Tigges happy. This 8-game winning streak would be impressive to turn into 9 as the Bears did handle North Union the first time around.
Capacious, another floater, and it pops in and out, no good. The rim spit that one back out, and North Union forces Garrigan to be one and done.
That was a great rebound by Merrill for North Union. She really battled for that one and pulled it down for the Warriors.
Merrill's averaging just under 8 rebounds per game for North Union as Ulrich drives across the foul line, picks it up and gives it to the curling Jones. Jones sees an opening, takes it down Main Street, banged it off the bottom of the rim, no good, and Eastman rebounds. Bartolo into the front court, passes to the cutting Aulish along the baseline, finds Capacious, ball off her hands low and right to Stevens for North Union. Stevens runs, comes up to the near side as Garrigan narrowly avoids a foul. Stevens deals outside to Ulrich, right wing three-pointer, lets it fly and ties the game. Ainsley Ulrich from downtown.
Boy, Ulrich busted for traveling in 2 possessions in a row. This time she says, don't let my feet screw it up, I'm going to drain this 3. Nice shot by Ulrich from deep.
Well, North Union already doing better than last time these teams matched up. They went 0 of 13 on three-pointers in that game. Eastman working around the baseline, deals to Montag. Corner pocket, Trey, too strong. Eastman offensive board, though. She's in a sandwich and has to get it out and finds Aulish. Aulish catch and shoot on the three, and it rims out, no good. Fight for the rebound in the lane, and a foul on Abby Capacious for Bishop Garrigan.
Yep, that'll be an easy call on Capacious. She went up for the ball, but arms went over the top and created a lot of contact there. And Garrigan now will set up the press. Now in for the
Golden Bears. Well, Garrigan will press this. What's the Hoagland checks in for Sasha Aulish? That first game against North Union was one of the four times this season Garrigan's held an opponent to zero threes. The first time around against Garner, Cardinals went 0-9. West Hancock went 0-11. And Eagle Grove had an 0-14 three-point shooting game against Garrigan. Opponent shooting just over 22% on threes this season against the Golden Bears. But North Union got their first one early by Ulrich as Stevens goes right side. Picked up by Hoagland defensively. 2:59 left in the first quarter. Stevens works the dribble. Bounces to Merrill right side. Merrill back out to Stevens on the wing. Stevens to the foul line. Gets it back to Merrill on the post. Merrill versus Eastman. What a matchup. Merrill tries to go up and under. Eastman stays in front. Merrill, tough jumper. She hits it.
Wow, two good post players tonight, folks. Merrill and Eastman having a great matchup. No fouls on either of them yet. Fear a few fouls in the game.
That was great defense by Eastman, but better offense by Merrill. Just so, so patient on that move. Didn't try to force a shot that wasn't there. Capacious passes the cutting Eastman. Bangs it off the glass, no good. Ball kicks out towards Stevens in the right corner. Stevens for North Union. Warriors up 9-7 right now over the Golden Bears in quarter number one. 2:22 on the clock. North Union has lost 10 straight games to Garrigan. Their last win over the Golden Bears was December 14th of 2018. A 39-36 Warrior win in that game. Orrick left across the foul line, now spinning right. 15-foot jumper, rolls on the rim and drops through. The jumpers are going down for North Union. They're up by four.
Well, good shot creation there off the dribble. Good pull-up jumper. Both these teams.
Jones tries to jump a pass. She knocks it off of Montag and forces another Golden Bear turnover.
Yeah, both these teams are really showing impressive conditioning this point in the season. They've been playing a lot of games. They're in basketball shape. No excuses about conditioning. And there's been very few substitutions by either coach. Both teams are getting the most out of their girls here. Five straight minutes for many of them.
Yeah, Warriors don't use a whole lot in their rotation. Their only bench player to play every game has been the freshman Shaylee Walters, who we've not yet seen so far tonight. Ulrich right side, jumps and passes. Now it's down underneath towards Steinberger. Almost got knocked away. She'll kick it out to Ulrich. Ulrich three off the back iron. And Capacious drops the rebound and picks it up for North Union. And speaking of which, Walters actually just checked in for the Warriors. The freshman wearing jersey number two. From way downtown, Emmy Bartolo missed on the three. Long rebound deflects out towards Montag, but it's picked up by Ulrich. Ulrich runs the floor. Ulrich in transition for two.
Ulrich looking fast on the floor. Makes it with her left hand. Ulrich's having a great first quarter scoring.
This is a different player than the one that Garrigan saw early in the season. Much more experienced in her freshman year. Capacious powers inside. Layup no good. Ball deflects toward the far side. Capacious tries to swat it out. Bartolo saves it along the boundary. That is a saving play there by Capacious and Bartolo. Bartolo drives right side of the lane. Wraps the pass into Eastman. Eastman off glass for two.
Wow, what shot creation by Bartolo. I thought she was going to get stopped because she drove straight into two people, but she knifed through and was able to dish the ball to Eastman under the hoop.
First non-capacious bucket for Bishop Garrigan. That will break up a 9-0 scoring run by North Union. Jones in the right side corner with 42 seconds left in the first. Jones picks up her dribble and goes right wing to Ulrich. Ulrich, right side against Bartolo, into the corner to Walters. Eyes the bucket, but passes up the three. Still 14 on the shot clock for North Union. Ulrich into the paint now. Ulrich pivots, and Ulrich with her third traveling violation. They're calling that one tight.
She drives hard into the lane, and then she tries to plant that pivot foot, but then she drags her pivot foot. And now we get some more substitutions into the game. Montag and Eastman coming out for Garrigan.
Murphy and Aulish will enter the ball game. Merrill will come back in for North Union as Jones will head to the bench. And Garrigan will have the shot clock off. 30 seconds on the game clock, down 13-9 against North Union.
We'll see if they're patient and try to work all 30 seconds off. It looks that way as Emmy Bartolo casually brings the ball up the floor.
22 seconds left in the first quarter, and North Union with a great start on the road. Bartolo dribbles up near half court right now. She'll burn some clock. We're down to 15 seconds left in the first quarter. The 17-1 Golden Bears against the 13-4 Warriors. A battle of two state-ranked teams. Aulish deep on the left wing with 8 seconds. Sidearms to Bartolo, right side of six. Right corner, Capacious of five. Back to Bartolo. Quick move in Hoagland. Releases the three. Missed it off to the right. Rebound by North Union's Walters, and that is the end of the first quarter. North Union jumps out to the early lead on the road, and they lead Bishop Garrigan 13-9 on KLGA 92.7 and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain Pellet Grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen, when you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
North Union throwing the first punch against Bishop Garrigan as the Warriors lead 13-9 in this top of Iowa West girls basketball matchup. North Union has the ball to start the second quarter. It's Walters, Stevens, Merrill, Steinberger, and Jones right now as Stevens almost blew a tire in the backcourt, but keeps the basketball as Aulish swats at it. For Garrigan, it's Aulish, Eastman, Capacious, Montag, and Bartolo. Stevens heads left around the perimeter. She gives the dribble handoff off to Jones. Now Jones to Walters, top of the key. Walters starts to drive. Deals into the corner to Steinberger. Throws it over the head of Walters and saved by Bartolo into bounds. But that's taken back by Walters. North Union dodged a bullet there. A near turnover.
And the shot clock will reset on a quick change of possessions for both teams.
Walters right side. Bartolo takes it right out of her hands. She picked the pocket. Up to Aulish in transition. Aulish right side. Layup no good. Bartolo with the rebound and she'll bring it back outside. Bartolo gets it top of the key towards Aulish. Sasha Aulish or Bishop Garrigan sidesteps and gives it off to Bartolo. Freshman Bartolo, second in the conference in assists, gets it into Capacious. Capacious, no good, missing the jumper from the lane right, but Eastman tracks down the long rebound. Back into Capacious. It rolls off her hands, though, and out of bounds. Capacious against Merrill that time, and the Golden Bears will not get another shot off in that possession.
Well, what a great first quarter. Both teams playing great. North Union wins the first quarter, and the second quarter, the first minute's been pretty ugly.
Yeah, back and forth. We were commenting there in the timeout, Beanie, that was a fast-moving first quarter. Not a lot of fouls. No timeouts taken. Not many turnovers as Jones drives right of a paint, and she shuffled the shoes as well. Warriors are having trouble simply with the travel so far tonight.
Yeah, it's like that floor is slick out there for the Warriors. They got to get some stick-em over there on their shoes because they're just having a hard time planting that pivot foot without dragging it, and the officials got to make that call. But credit Capacious there. Jones is very fast, trying to turn that corner and drive, and Capacious making it difficult for her.
6:47 on the clock here at the Golden Bear High School Gymnasium. Best crowd of the season. Both sides are packed tonight for this close proximity rivalry. Eastman in the post. Eastman puts it up over Merrill on a soft touch. Eastman puts it in.
That was a good look at the post. Coach Schwab loves to use those post players. Eastman got a lot of points, averaged a game. And finally getting her first two there in the second quarter.
North Union leads Bishop Garrigan 13-11 as Walters has the ball across half court, heading towards the left. Gives to Naomi Jones. Jones averaging 11.4 points per game. Underhands it out to Ulrich. Ulrich to the elbow, kicks it over to Jones. Jones wants the drive. Jones floater. Jones got fouled and she put it down. Chance for a three-point play by Naomi Jones.
Oh, Naomi Jones, we've seen her year after year, just excellent at driving to the hoop. She's a weapon, handles the ball great, and she's very good at driving to the basket. That time, she had to put a nice touch on the floater, swishes it through for the Warriors.
And Jones is pretty open in the corner. A lot of players would have taken that three, but Jones is so confident in that floater. She's very confident taking the ball into traffic as she hits the free throw, makes it 16-11. Warriors do not take a whole lot of threes. In fact, the least in the conference, 12.7 threes per game as Capacious is at the foul line. Deals out to Aulish. Left wing tray. Aulish rims out. Rebound to Eastman, though. Eastman in a sandwich. Eastman takes a dribble, shoots over Merrill. She got fouled. Olivia Merrill got her on the hand, and that'll be two free throws for Eastman. They're really swarming Eastman, though, when she gets that offensive board. They're keeping her in between two defenders and forcing her to try to make a tough pass out of that or a tough shot out of that.
Yes, you can see these two teams strategizing what they want to do to the other. Garrigan's putting a lot of pressure on Stevens and Jones, trying to keep them out of the game. Coach Tigges and North Union, they're letting Capacious have that ball at the high post, and they're really keeping Eastman out of the game, which has worked for them because Garrigan has missed their three-point shots. I don't think we've seen many quarters where Garrigan doesn't hit a three. I don't think they had one in that first quarter. So Coach Schwab, he's going to go into Eastman, gets the ball in there, and she gets rewarded with free throw, but missed it.
Missed both the free throws, and North Union still leads by five. Ulrich at the elbow gets it out to Stevens, left side, with 5:50 left in the second quarter. Golden Bears, like I said, not hitting their threes yet. They're second in the conference, shooting their threes at a 31.3% rate. Right corner to Stevens, looking for Merrill in the post. Got behind Eastman, Montag with the help, but a push by Bishop Garrigan. Eastman was trying to front Merrill that time in the post, and Garrigan will pick up their second foul of the quarter as Eastman was the guilty party for her first.
Merrill drew the foul, but just before she made a nice pass that would have resulted in an easy bucket, Coach Tigas probably would have liked to have that easy bucket, but the foul was called. And, boy, both coaches have amped it up the second quarter. They turned it up to 11 on their bench here.
Merrill on the elbow, gives the handoff off to Ulrich. Ulrich lost the basketball, and it's taken away by Bartolo. Bartolo gets it up to Capacious. Capacious looks for the baseline, gets turned back outside by Jones as she's on the far side of the court. Bartolo on the wing. Rainbows up the three. It's a little bit too strong. Rebound for Eastman. Power dribble, put back, and that one's too long as well. Jones has the basketball for North Union. Eastman's got a lot of offensive boards so far, but not the putback tonight.
Jones thought about pushing the tempo and maybe going coast to coast and just put the brakes on because Coach Tigas wants to set up a play here.
And Merrill looks to get bumped there on the high post. Nothing called, though. Left corner three. Stevens, and she drills it. That's better than a foul for the Warriors, and they're up by eight.
Yeah, I will say it for this game. The inside play, they're letting them play. It is physical on both ends, calling it both ways.
Down to the baseline, Capacious works around out to Aulish, and it goes out of bounds. Golden Bears not in sync right now offensively. Warriors' physical defense is bothering them early in this game.
Yep, but you see a lot of pats on the back and a lot of encouragement on both teams. You know, Tyler, when you got it rolling, you encourage each other, and when it's going bad, you encourage each other, and that's what both the Warriors and the Bears are up to.
Garrigan's going to go for the zone defense this possession. Out to the right side is Stevens with 4:35 on the clock. Top of the key, Jones bounce pass left wing. Ulrich, catch and release for three. Ulrich a little bit too long. Rebound contested, and it deflects over to Montag. Coach Schwab was saying that Merrill committed the foul against Eastman that time, but as you said, Beanie, they're letting him go at it tonight. Aulish dribbles in front of the North Union bench, comes across the foul line, pass Capacious, jump by Jones. Here comes Naomi Jones, streaking down the floor, getting to the cup, missing the layup though, she came in too hot. Stevens reverses, and her layup misses as well. Garrigan dodges two bullets.
Big missed opportunity for the Warriors there. Could have had an easy bucket, couldn't convert.
Quick tempo, Aulish tried to cross up, but she crossed up before she put the ball in the hardwood and she travels.
Yeah, you can see the Bears are definitely trying to pick up the tempo and take advantage of their depth, get North Union tired out. They're trying to run the floor right now. Didn't work that time. So, Tyler, going back to what we've been commenting about, the letting them play, you know, you like to see the officials call fouls, and they are, but you kind of want it to let a little post play go just so people can play physical down there. And, you know, there's two starting post players. I think both coaches want to keep them in the game, and I don't think they'll complain about a lack of fouls too much.
Bartolo reaching in, knocks the ball away from Ulrich and forces a tie-up. Possession arrow towards Garrigan. And it's so interesting to see because we've seen Merrill for years from North Union. She's been a really good post player for them. And now you have the new freshman Eastman coming in and really creating an interesting dynamic in this matchup as Coach Tigas calls the timeout at the 3:44 mark of quarter number two. So timeout called by Coach Tigas. It's a 60, so we'll take it with him as well on KLGA 92.7 and at the Elgorda Radio YouTube live stream.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
It's North Union 19, Bishop Garrigan 11. 3:39 on the clock in quarter number two as Garrigan nearly threw the ball away again. In the high post to Eastman, and now they do throw it away. Ball's on the floor, and it went out to Montag. Three green jerseys around the ball as the ball goes underneath to Capacious. Pivots around and works back outside to Bartolo. Bartolo to the right wing to Montag. Releases the three, left it a little short, and Jones with a box out of Capacious. Jones striding into the front court. The North Union senior averaging 5.8 rebounds per game this year has it left corner. Guarded by Montag. Golden Bears down 19-11 right now as Stevens brings the ball in between the circles. Stevens looks for Jones deep on the left wing. Warriors have a patient possession. The pass far side of the court to Stevens. Dribbles back towards the center and bounces the pass over to Jones. Jones takes a couple dribbles towards the right. Jumps and passes to Stevens' right side. Eyes the bucket. Slices in. Rises for a mid-range. Jay missed it long. And Eastman vacuums in another rebound.
Good shot creation by Stevens there. She drove in and created that jump shot.
Eastman averaging 9.6 rebounds per game, had a double-double against Belmont Clemmie, her eighth of the season, as she barrels her way inside and scored it.
Good bucket by Eastman. She started at the elbow, took two dribbles, a nice right-hand shot. That was an old six-on-six shot right there, the two dribbles and up.
Well, 7 points by Capacious, six by Eastman for Bishop Garrigan. None of the three-point shooters have gotten on track yet. On the left wing, it's Ulrich with 2:22 left in the first half. Ulrich heading in, getting it top of the key to Stevens. Stevens slicing in, got past the defense, floater no good, got her own miss back, puts it up, and she spun it in. Stevens with a two, and it's 21-13.
Really high off the glass. Nice touch by Stevens.
Hoagland deep on the left wing, gets it between the circles to Bartolo, now right side Montag. High post to Eastman, turns around, she'll rise for a jumper, and she missed it right. Merrill snatches them away the rebound. 1:55 left in the first half. North Union leading Bishop Garrigan, trying to break a 10-game losing streak to the Golden Bears and keep their 8-game winning streak this season going. Top of the key, it's Jones, passing it left to Stevens, drops and picks it back up. Stevens dribbles towards the center of the court. She'll fling it over to Ulrich. High passes. Ulrich jumps to make the catch. Ulrich back out to Stevens. Stevens sets herself a free. Off the heel, no good. And the rebound near the foul line to Eastman. Eastman will bring it into the front court. Waits for Bartolo to get across and gives it out to the Bishop Garrigan point guard. The sophomore Bartolo flings left to the sophomore Hoagland. Eastman high post. Eastman driving in. Splits two defenders. Hits out the bottom of the backboard, but she got fouled.
Yep, they gave the body contact call. Garrigan has moved Eastman to the high post to put Abby Capacious down on the baseline just to give that North Union defense a different type of challenge. And Eastman is getting the ball and just driving straight to the hoop.
So Eastman at the foul line, the number two scorer in the top of Iowa West at 16.7 points per game as Eastman misses the free throw, and she's 0 for 3 at the line so far tonight. Walters checks in as Steinberg checks out. Allish checks in as Montag checks out. Both teams make one sub.
So interesting adjustment by the teams. Putting Eastman at the high post makes Merrill for North Union decide whether she has to come out from under the basket or not.
Eastman free throw, missed it right. A tough night at the foul line so far for Eastman, and Merrill boxes out for the rebound.
Boy, major improvement. This rebounding by Merrill's been fantastic tonight.
That was something Coach Schwab referenced in the pregame. He said North Union is a much better rebounding team than the first time these two teams matched up. 1:06 left in the first half. North Union will take a lead in the halftime. Just is a question of how much. A lob towards Merrill. It tips away. Eastman got a finger on it, and Allish comes out with the ball. Allish with a little pace into the front court. Allish stops and tries to pass right to Bartolo. Stevens jumps it. Here comes Libby Stevens. Stevens in the paint. Her layup went through the wrong part of the cup, and it's rebounded by Garrigan. That went underneath the rim and went up through.
Yeah, it went underneath up through. I've never seen that before, Tyler. What if it drops back down through?
A no bucket, I think, as Eastman goes inside, gets fouled by Merrill. Yeah, that is not a way to get a bucket, but it would have looked cool if it happened.
That did look cool. Boy, you see Eastman driving to the lane again. Every time she does that, she picks up another foul on the Warriors, that time on number 21.
That is Olivia Merrill picking up her second. So Garrigan is starting to get North Union into a few fouls here near the end of the first half as Eastman in and out on the free throw.
And Merrill's going to have to come out of the game, and that is huge because she's set to get a rebounder inside. You know, they've been letting the post play both, you know, they can push and shove on each other down underneath the hoop. But on drives to the basket, that's when you get those fouls called.
Free throw Eastman, that one rims out as well. Eastman with six misses in a row from the foul line. It's 21-13, still in favor of North Union. Warriors can milk this one down to the end of the clock. Shot clock and game clock are separated by about half a second as Jones and Stevens are content to go back and forth near half court. This has been a tremendous defensive performance so far by North Union. As right now, we're down to 15 seconds left. Walters deep on the right wing, gets it back between the circles towards Stevens. We're down to 11 seconds. To the left side to Jones of 10. Action's going to start here soon. Jones to the right of 7. Jones stops, bounce pass towards Walters. Dangerous pass of 4 seconds. Stevens a 3. Short corner jumper. And it swirls into the cup at the buzzer. Libby Stevens knocks it down. North Union up by 10 against Bishop Garrigan as we head to halftime. The Golden Bears 68-game win streak at the top of Iowa West is on the line tonight. North Union up by 10 on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
SignWorks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game. We've got more Sports Club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
SignWorks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Halftime here on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream in this girls basketball matchup between two state-ranked teams. The North Union Warriors lead the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears 23-13. The scoring by quarter featured North Union jumping out to a 13-9 lead at the end of one, and then outscoring Bishop Garrigan 10-4 during that second quarter. I'm Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodie. Right now the halftime ceremony going on as it's law enforcement night here at the gymnasium, so the police officers from around the area are being honored here at halftime. But right now here, as far as the basketball game is concerned, Garrigan down by 10. Beanie, it had to be forever since the last time Garrigan's been held to 4 points in the quarter, but that's exactly what happened. Coach Takas has had a great defensive game plan for North Union. The Golden Bears are all out of whack on offense, and they need to find some of that perimeter shooting, some more foul shooting as well to get back into this one.
Oh, for sure. The three-point shooting for Garrigan has not been there, and whenever a team's not making their three-pointers like usual, you always have to ask the question, are they just cold, or is it the North Union defense is just doing such a stellar job keeping them off that three-point line and getting a hand in their face? We've seen some deep threes for Garrigan because they want to get those shots up. But then Garrigan adjusts and goes inside. That worked, but Grayson Eastman missing some free throws here. And, yeah, here we are, 10-point lead. And, boy, we can talk basketball, Tyler, but I got to say, this is a very impressive halftime going on. We got everyone in the county here that's a basketball fan standing on their feet. They've been clapping for four straight minutes at the law enforcement officers that are on the floor here. And there are alumni from both schools. There's North Union alumni down there on the floor. There's Garrigan alumni down the floor. And just a lot of familiar faces as people support their law enforcement. Of course, every game in the county typically has an officer cruising by the building, just checking things out, making sure everything's okay. But Roger Fisher, the county sheriff, hails from the north part of the county, and he just got a big round of applause. And, boy, this is the longest standing ovation I've seen in a long time here. This is very impressive here in the Bishop Garrigan Gymnasium.
Yeah, and it's as packed here as it's been in a long time. like I said earlier, both sides are pretty much entirely full, and it's created a great environment here tonight, and it's an environment where North Union has thrived so far, up 13-4 right now. And, you know, offensively for the Warriors, Beanie, their identity is pretty simple. They're not going to shoot a whole lot of threes, not going to focus on perimeter shooting, but they'll get the occasional three aims the O-Arc, but a lot of it, it's post touches for Olivia Mirwell. It's the higher low post. It's penetrating off the dribble for Stevens and O-Arc and Jones, and it's finding a way to just shift the Garrigan defense to their liking and create those looks in the paint.
Yeah, outstanding patience. They know Garrigan's got this good 2-3 defense, and Garrigan will easily match up into man out of that 2-3, and they are prepared. They know how to attack that defense, and they're doing so with really good guard play. Jones and Stevens and Ulrich are really choosing their moments. They're really good shot selection is what I'm trying to say. They're not forcing bad shots, and they're shooting at a really high percentage and knocking down those buckets. And that's the recipe for getting yourself out to a lead. Excellent first half by the Warriors, but their defense, holding Garrigan to 13 points, boy, that hasn't happened in a long time.
Yes, and even in the post-Crooks, post-Royce era, this Garrigan team is one of the top five offenses in Class 1A and the top offense in points per game in the North Central Conference, in the top Iowa West Conference. But, you know, opposing coaches talk all the time about the efficiency of the Garrigan offense, and tonight they haven't been efficient so far. You know, the shots not going down. The free throws haven't gone down as well either for Garrigan. So, you know, it's been an inefficient night offensively, down 23-13 at the half, but still a chance for them to get back at it into the second half if they can start to get some three-point shooting going and continue to get to the foul line, because they got to the foul line quite a bit towards the end of the first half. You know, they didn't hit their free throws, but you got to keep getting the ball inside and trying to get North Union in foul trouble and getting those free throw attempts in any case.
Oh, sure, and while it's the patience for the North Union team on offense that has been fantastic, Garrigan's just going to have to be patient with their offense too. Like, they're going to score. The shots will come down. They just have to be persistent, stick with their game plan, keep working that high-low post game. It's been working well. Shots haven't fallen. Capacious start out the game, scoring 7 straight points, and it looked like it was going to be easy, but then North Union turned up the defense. My question is, can North Union maintain this defense the whole rest of the way? Olivia Merrill picked up a second foul there right there at the end of the half.
Yes.
She played just an outstanding half of basketball. Great rebounding, good interior play. Her and Eastman are having a fantastic battle underneath the basket, but that will be something to watch. Can Merrill keep up this fantastic play and stay out of foul trouble? That's going to be a recipe. A very good game between both teams so far. Things just not coming as easily for Garrigan to have, and that's a testament to the improvement of the North Union team. The first time we did this game up there in the North Union Gymnasium, I think I can use the word blowout.
Yeah, it was. It got to a running clock.
Yeah, it got to a running clock, and wow, what a turnaround. Credit Coach Tigges, great coach, been coaching for a long time. And he has his girls much, much improved, not just on how they're playing the game, but their fundamentals have improved as well, as you see them work on their footwork and get position and move the ball around. And, hats off to a much improved North Union team. While it was a blowout up there, this one's a game, and that's fun.
This one is a game. Bishop Garrigan has won 68 straight top of Iowa West games. They've won 48 straight at home. Both those date back to January 10th of 2020, when they lost 56-55 against West Hancock during the freshman year of Crooks and Joyce. Beanie, I'll ask you this. Garrigan wins in the second half, if what? And North Union holds on in the second half, if what?
North Union holds on in the second half if they continue to limit their turnovers as they did in the second quarter. Very good ball handling. And if I really think it really rides a lot on Olivia Merrill's shoulders. If she keeps playing good defense on Eastman and she stays in the game and keeps up that great post play, that could result in a victory for North Union. But that's out the window if Garrigan starts getting hot from three-point shooting. Like, they have five three-point shooters that, if they get going, move that ball around and start dropping those three-pointers, there's not many teams that can stop that no matter what you do.
So Bishop Garrigan trailing North Union 23-13 at the half. We'll take one final timeout and bring you the second half of action after this on 92.7 KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires, they're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Back to Bishop Garrigan High School here on Hometown Radio KLGA as the North Union Warriors lead the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears 23-13. Golden Bears did not have a single made three during that first half. Abby Pace led the way of 7 points as Graceland Eastman had six for the Golden Bears. Warriors, though, held the Golden Bears to 4 points during the second quarter. Bishop Garrigan will try to get back on track offensively in the start of the second half with Eastman, Aulish, Bartolo, Montag, and Capacious on the floor. For North Union, they will have Steinberger, Merrill, Ulrich, Jones, and Stevens. That'll be the five as North Union has the basketball to start the second half. It'll be Ulrich inbounding from the far side as the Warriors will head left to right on the radio dial, and we'll get the second half basketball action underway from a packed Bishop Garrigan High School gymnasium. Ulrich looking and bouncing it into Stevens into the backcourt, and we're rolling here in the second half. North Union up by 10, trying to break a 10-game losing streak to the Golden Bears dating back to 2018. Golden Bears trying to avoid their first conference loss since early 2020. Ulrich to the foul line, 15-footer on the way, rims out, no good, and Montag the uncontested rebound. Warriors focusing on getting back on defense as Montag gives to Capacious on the right side. Has it between the circles as she comes left to Bartolo. Bartolo heads right around the perimeter. Passes to Capacious, right side baseline, now into the corner to Bartolo. Lobs it to Capacious, down on the baseline, goes around Merrill, tried to find Eastman, drops, picks it up. Tough angle on the layup, no good. Rebound towards the left baseline, and it's picked up by Jones as Aulish goes crashing down to the hardwood. Into the front court, Jones slings the pass into the corner. Ulrich free, and she swished it. What a start to the second half by North Union.
Well, you're not wrong there. They don't shoot that many threes, but Ulrich, she's hot. She hit one in the first, and that was big. And Schwab is upset.
He may have just gotten a technical foul.
Yeah, I think so. He's real upset. Sasha Aulish hit the deck, and it was because Jones got the rebound. And Aulish tried to tap the ball away. Jones maintained control of it over in the corner. And as Jones tried to clear the ball, she didn't do anything wrong, but Aulish got tangled up and went flying.
Boy, I guess not. I don't know if they just warned both sides. They brought both coaches kind of towards the middle and explained something, but I don't know. I'm at a loss. I got to be honest.
I'm confused. Do you get a warning? I think maybe Coach Schwab got a warning. I'm not sure, but Garrigan has the ball.
Eastman with a nice move against Merrill. Missed the layup. Got her own miss back. Cleanup good. Well, Ainsley Oracle, 12 points right now for North Union. Eastman leading the way with 8 for Bishop Garrigan on his 26-15 Warriors. Jones pulls up and passes right side to Ulrich. Guarded by Bartolo. Ulrich got the ball poked away by Bartolo, but it rolls out to Stevens. Stevens driving in, bounce pass to the baseline, as she will find Steinberger. Montag trying to rake at the ball and knock it out as Steinberger goes back to left wing to Jones. Jones across the foul line, hits the spin move, deals back to the top of the key to Stevens. The screen by Merrill. Stevens now reverses course and heads right. Pass down towards the block towards Jones, goes out of bounds, and who touched it last? It was last touched by Garrigan.
Garrigan trying to set their defense here. The intensity is definitely ratcheted up. When Ulrich hit that three-pointer, the Garrigan team, if they're feeling the pressure, they're down 11 here, 6:19 left in the third.
Well, Ulrich takes 6.6 threes per game, so she's taking more than half of North Union's three-point attempts on a nightly basis. She steps back. She fought about the three. That time she'll drive instead. Left the ball behind, though, and Bartolo has it. Bartolo pulls up. Now she hesitates. She drives in. Got by Ulrich, and the layup misses. Montag clean up and puts it in.
Big board by Montag. I'm sure Coach Schwab challenged them to get to those boards.
And the beautiful hesitation, too, by Bartolo, but did everything but finish. Stevens gets the ball across half court for North Union. 26-17 Warriors. It's a single-digit game right now at the 5:52 mark of quarter number three. Stevens heading in. Stevens stopped at the foul line. Aulish playing great defense. Right side Jones against Capacious. Jones driving in. Help defense. Eastman on a foul. That's going to be the second on Graceland Eastman, and Jones will be shooting, too.
Boy, Stevens was trying so hard to drive and get to the hoop. Aulish wouldn't let her. She gives it up to Jones, and her compadre gets to the hoop. Draws a foul on Eastman. That'll be two on her. So now both posts playing with two fouls here early in the second half.
Free throw Jones off the back iron. No good. Naomi Jones, 52.3% from the charity stripe so far this season. Warriors as a team four from the conference, shooting 58.6% as a unit. Jones' second free throw goes down the drain, and North Union's up by 10 in the third quarter. Into the front court comes Emmy Bartolo for Bishop Garrigan. Bartolo flings left side to Capacious. Now it's Aulish in front of the Garrigan bench. Aulish crosses over, splits two defenders, threads the pass towards Eastman, but Aulish traveled first.
Eastman had a really nice pin on the inside. She had Merrill on her back, and Alish was trying to get to that pass, but she traveled before she could make that assist.
Garrigan will bring out some full court pressure against Ulrich. It's Bartolo defending. Ulrich bursts into the front court, but that is going to be a foul. I believe that's going to be Bartolo of her first, and the second team foul on Garrigan as Bartolo picks that one up.
Yeah, Garrigan putting on the press, trying to create some turnovers down 10 here, and that's why ball handling is always at a premium here in this gymnasium, because Garrigan puts on the press, but Coach Tigges has got some ball handlers and much improved, as we talked earlier.
Merrill collects the pass in the backcourt and then hands it right back off to Stevens. Stevens averaging just under 11 points per game for North Union this season, as she has 7 so far tonight. Stevens bounce pass towards Ulrich left wing. Bartolo tried to take that ball away and force a tie-up. She even put both her thumbs in the air, dives and can't get the ball from Ulrich, who gets it off to Stevens. Stevens heads right across the foul line. Stevens, right side, bounce pass towards Jones. Jones into the post to Merrill. Merrill works against Eastman, drops the ball, picks it up, pivots 360, puts up the shot, fading back, no good. Rebound pinballs away. Ulrich picks it up in the lane.
Wow, good defense by Eastman. Great post moves by Merrill, but Eastman blocks him out.
4:53 left in the third quarter. Coach Schwab extremely animated on the sideline during that last defensive possession for Garrigan. Ulrich between the circles, finds Capacious high post. Capacious drives in, floats over Merrill. Capacious in and out. Eastman cleanup. Eastman got fouled. Eastman getting all kinds of offensive rebounds tonight, and she'll get to the free throw line, sitting on 8 points right now.
You know, Capacious, the senior, had a good look. It didn't go. Eastman cleans it up. The freshman, that senior and freshman have really formed a pretty good bond this year. Capacious being a great leader by example. And boy, this freshman does not look like a freshman as Eastman hits the free throw.
9 points for Graceland Eastman. Ashel, get ready for the second one. It's 27-18 as Eastman left the second one short. Rebound briefly controlled by Ulrich, but you can't save it as it goes out along the baseline. Garrigan nearly was able to go 2-for-1 there, but they will turn it over at the 4:39 mark. And they will continue to full court press. Abby Capacious will guard the inbounder Stevens on the right side baseline. Warriors bounce it into Jones. Ulrich tried to jump that and steal it as Jones brings it to the front court, throws it to Ulrich. It's off her fingertips and out of bounds. That was a quarterback trying to throw a touchdown and just overthrew the receiver.
Yeah, missed opportunity for the Warriors. Ulrich went for the steal, but didn't get it. That put Jones on the loose, and Jones was going to convert, but threw the pass a little too far.
Capacious just inside of half court for Bishop Garrigan. Had a double-double against Belmont Clemmy last night. Into Eastman. Eastman trying to fight through the defense, and she'll draw a foul. That one was on the floor.
What a pass by Capacious to Eastman. Throws a perfect lob in there. Eastman had almost triple coverage on her, and it did become triple as soon as the ball was there. She picks up the foul. Now Garrigan can do what some of the times, the easiest time to score when you're struggling offensively. You can get an out-of-bounds underneath the hoop, get a quick bucket, and turn it around.
Walters checks in for Steinberger. Inbound pass to Capacious. Puts it in and got fouled. Abby Capacious with a three-point chance. And Bishop Garrigan trims their deficit down to 7.
Yeah, and that's just what they needed. That out-of-bounds play to Capacious. Hard to the hoop. Bounce pass from out-of-bounds right under the hoop. You're not going to stop Capacious when she's playing a little one-on-one game next to the hoop. She is strong and tough to the rack.
Yeah, Capacious always finds a way to finish down there as her free throw's good. Capacious this season, first in the top of Iowa West and fourth in Class 1A, shooting just under 59% on field goals this year. As Merrill's marooned in the corner, Merrill in trouble. Merrill's got a pass away to Jones, makes a one-handed catch. Now Jones bursting into the front court, sprinting by Montag. Jones out to Walters, arcs up a three off the front of the cup, and Jones bats the rebound out. It's going out of bounds, and Jones touched it last. Nearly a saving rebound for North Union.
You know, when North Union broke the press a second ago, that was an incredible catch by Jones. Leaped up in the air, one-handed it. But this pressure from Garrigan is definitely going to cause some problems because they are really going for it.
Bartolo bursting into the lane, sidearming it out to Ulrich. Deep tray, rims out, no good. And the rebound in the lane by Stevens. North Union, or make that Bishop Garrigan, has only been involved in 2 single-digit scoring games this year. Garrigan 2-0 in games decided by single digits. Right now, though, they're down by 6 as the pass is thrown away by North Union. Stevens threw it to Ulrich, but it's out of bounds.
Yeah, Emmy Bartolo, a great pressure over there. Both Bartolo and Ulrich, they've been hitting the deck, trying everything they can, and Garrigan's got some momentum now. Coach Schwab clapping, likes what he sees now. Tigges will talk it over with his group.
30-second timeout called by North Union, and you can feel some of that momentum trying to shift back to Garrigan. Abby Capacious is clapping and high-fiving teammates, and Garrigan trying to get some momentum. Right now, Capacious with 10 points, and this might be a situation. You've got the young team. Now you've got to lean on the senior a little bit. This is a season-defining moment potentially for Capacious. You want to keep that conference winning streak going if she can put the team on their back and get Garrigan back in front here.
Yeah, for sure. And that out-of-bounds play where she got the three-point conversion was huge. She was pumped up after that. Yeah, she's going, and everyone's following her lead. You know, they're also following their coaches' lead. Coach Tigas imploring his team to keep staying the course. They're in a great situation right now. And Coach Schwab, he is fired up, and he's trying to rally his team. And his they're both teams reflecting the attitudes of their coaches at this point.
Bartolo brings the ball across half court for Bishop Garrigan. Down to 3:40 in the third quarter. Nice pass underneath Montag and the score. What a find by Emmy Bartolo. 4.4 assists per game, and passes like that are why it's a four-point game right now. Garrigan has scored the last 6 points, if my math is correct here. Stevens brings the ball out beyond the three-point line. Bounce pass right corner to Jones. Drives baseline. Montag forces her down, and it's out of bounds. The great defense by Montag, and Jones will turn it over.
Yeah, Jones tried to go baseline, and it just got herself blocked on that baseline and kind of trapped. And here she goes back the other way. Coach Tigas doesn't like that call very much, and here comes Bartolo.
This would be a huge possession for Garrigan if they find a way to score here. 3:09 left in the third quarter. Garrigan down by four. Bartolo bobbles the ball up top, comes left towards Aulish, tipped away by Stevens. Ball loose, picked up by Eastman as she saves it. Kicks to Capacious. Corner pocket three off the back of the cup. And the rebound out to the foul line to Ulrich. Ulrich will bring the ball across half court. The North Union freshman hands the ball off towards Stevens as they're down to 2:50 left in the third quarter. Stevens dribbles just inside of half court, guarded by Aulish. She'll head right. She'll stop at the right wing, looking for Jones to shake loose. Jones in the corner, guarded by Capacious. Jones back to the bucket. Jones holding it. Jones holding, getting it out to Merrill. Merrill finds the cutting Walters. Walters, shot blocked by Montag. And now here comes Bartolo. 2.5 minutes left in the third. Bartolo gets it to Aulish from way downtown. Left it off the front of the rim. Loose rebound picked up by Walters. North Union forces Garrigan to go one and done. Here comes Walters. Finds the trailing Jones right side. Garrigan down by four. It's 27-23. North Union will set the screen if Merrill. It's Stevens slicing in, and Stevens will be pushed and fouled. That's number three against Garrigan this quarter.
Yeah, it's been, Garrigan's has been really ratcheting up the pressure. Difficult game to officiate. Whenever a team defensively amps up the pressure, there's a lot of calls down there to make.
Ulrich, right side corner. Ulrich looking to create with the dribble. Heads across the foul line. Gets by Bartolo. Kicks it out Stevens. Stevens catch and release three. Too strong, and rebound by Eastman. Almost threw it away as Ulrich nearly knocked it out. But it's taken by Bartolo. Here comes the Garrigan sophomore with 1:56 left in the third quarter. Still 27-23 as we're stuck on that score for the past few possessions. Aulish on the drive. Aulish threads the pass to Eastman. Knocked away the last minute by Jones. Had those good low hands.
You know, we talked about the assists that are made by Sasha Aulish. She sets up those assists. She sees them. She can predict what's going to open up. That time she knew Eastman was going to open up. And again, just before it was foiled.
Aulish lobs into Eastman, snatches it off the top of Walters. Eastman pivots around 360 and deals out to Montag right wing. Montag driving in, bounce pass to Eastman, posting against Merrill. Eastman puts it up, and it bounces in. It's a two-point game, and a timeout is called by North Union. 1:39 left in the third quarter, and this is getting interesting. We'll keep it right here. Garrigan with a concerted effort, that possession, Beanie, to get the ball inside to Eastman, and it paid off.
You bet. They wanted that shot. Coach Schwab came off pumped up because he got what they wanted. He got the bucket by Eastman. Merrill had to back off. She doesn't want to pick up another foul, so she played it soft, and Eastman converts a big bucket there. Two-point game. Boy, now from here, Garrigan probably just sticks to the same recipe. They're going to keep this defensive pressure up, and North Union's really going to have to answer it, which is a hard thing to do because their best chance, if Garrigan's going to put this pressure on, Naomi Jones almost did it a moment ago. She almost was able to break that pressure and go all the way for a bucket, but I don't know if Coach Tigas wants to play a fast-paced game at this point.
Well, you can feel the intensity right now. Coach Schwab trying to rally the troops in the Bishop Garrigan huddle. Meanwhile, North Union, they're in a little bit of a regroup mode right now. They had a double-digit lead for much of this second half, but Garrigan has gone on a run here towards the end of the third quarter and frittered it down to a two-point game. 27-25 North Union. What a treat when these two teams have matched up. You know, I will say this. A lot of times when Garrigan's played North Union in the past, the first matchup has been heavily in favor of Garrigan, but North Union, even in the past couple years when they've lost, they've gotten a lot closer the second time around. They've made adjustments after the first time they've seen Garrigan, and that's been exactly the case tonight. The first time around, a 35-point loss for North Union, and tonight, they're in a position to win, but it's going to be grinded out right down to the end. Whoa. They're leading by two here in the third.
The Warriors are in a tight spot here, trying to inbound it against a press out of a timeout. It's always hard.
Stevens can run the baseline, gets it into Merrill. Now out to Ulrich. Ulrich with a cool head of steam, and she gets it across half court. Ulrich's taking it in, right down the lane, puts it in. She got fouled. Chance for a three-point play by Ulrich. Nobody stops the ball for Bishop Garrigan.
Well, I thought Ulrich was making a huge mistake because she had Naomi Jones running the floor, and I thought she missed the pass for an easy Jones layup, but I guess the freshman knew, oh, no, I can take it all the way to the rack, get fouled, create a three-point play situation. Impressive coast-to-coast by Ulrich once she got the inbounds from Merrill.
The C's parted for Ulrich. Free throw off the back of the cup, no good. And Capacious vacuums in another rebound. Abby Capacious averaging a double-double this season of 12 points and 10 rebounds as Montag heads around the perimeter towards the left, jumps and passes towards Ulrich with 1:23 left. Ulrich having trouble keeping that dribble, kicks it into the corner. Bartolo, wide open free, and she drills it! Emmy Bartolo from downtown!
First three-pointer of the night for Bishop Garrigan comes at 1:11 left in the third.
And that was a big shot. It's a one-point game. Answering the bucket by Ulrich. Now Stevens slicing down the lane. Stevens off glass. No. Rebound by Eastman. Garrigan can take the lead. Into the front court comes Bartolo. Fakes the pass. One side goes to Capacious. Almost right behind her. Capacious with 55 seconds. Works the baseline. Jumps and passes. Swatted out by Jones on the active defense.
Wow, Jones is so athletic, but she's showing some wear and tear here. She looks a little worn down as she looks over to the bench for some coaching. Merrill's going to get a break. She had such a fantastic first half. They're going to need her the rest of the way. It's a one-point game.
Capacious at the top of the key. She'll head right. Bulletin into Eastman. Eastman pivots away from trouble. Tries to go up and under, and she got fouled. Eastman hit the ground hard that time, but she'll be pulled up by Capacious as she will shoot two.
Eastman was showing off her own repertoire of post footwork there. She kind of crossed over, came back the other way, tried to kind of do an underhand shot up at the hoop, gets herself to the line.
Eastman free throw, goes right down the chute, and we are tied at 29. Murphy and Hoagland check in for Bishop Garrigan. Montag and Capacious head to the bench. Graceland Eastman with 12 points so far tonight. Free throw on the way again, rattles into the cup. 13 points Eastman, and Garrigan has inched in front, 30-29. And the full court press, Murphy guards the inbounds, it's lobbed into Stevens, almost got bumped by Ulrich. The North Union crowd wanted the foul there, and now it's Walters at the far side of the court. Deals into the corner to Jones, fakes and drives, Jones across the lane. Jones goes in, blocked by Eastman, but a foul. Number three against Graceland Eastman, and Jones will shoot two.
Jones is really good at getting that ball in her right hand and driving hard to the right side of the hoop. Eastman got a lot of ball, but a lot of body as well. Jones earns a free throw. Tyler, 30-29 is the score. Garrigan up by one. Is this the first time Garrigan's led since the first quarter when Abby scored 7 points in a row? I think it is.
It is.
And we're tied again.
The free throw bounces in for Jones on the friendly rubber rim. Capacious in, Murphy out for Bishop Garrigan with 36 seconds left in the quarter. A 30-30 tie. And we're still tied. Free throw short. Pinballs out to Ulrich at the foul line.
Well, this is fun. We don't have a lot of Garrigan games with lead changes.
Ulrich deals out to Bartolo. As we said earlier, Garrigan's only played in two games this year, decided by single digits. One of those was a 67-62 win against Western Christian, where Garrigan led by double digits most of the way, but Western Christian kind of came back late in that one. Now 18 seconds left in the third quarter. Bartolo near half court, passing it left to Hoagland, now back to Bartolo. Bartolo into the lane to Eastman. Eastman dribbling right. Eastman powers it up, and she got fouled. 7 seconds left, and Eastman will shoot two free throws.
Yeah, Eastman, great job inside. Merrill is on the bench, and she's the one that's been defending Eastman the best, and they can't stop her. Coach Schwab says get that ball inside and get her to the line. Shoot with 7 seconds left, stopped on the clock.
Eastman free throw in and out. The other single-digit game Garrigan played in was a four-point win over Forest City, where Garrigan led by 15 at the end of the third quarter. Almost had Forest City come all the way back, but held on at the end. So the close games Garrigan has played have been games where one team led by a lot and the other team rallied. There hasn't been a back-and-forth like this so far this season. Eastman puts the free throw into the drain. 31-30, 7 seconds left. Third quarter. Stevens across half court to three. Stevens pulls up. Three-point ball, and she missed it left. That's the end of the third quarter. Bishop Garrigan has inched back in front, 31-30, but still a ton to be decided here at the Garrigan High School Gymnasium. One-point game as we head to the fourth on KLGA 92.7 and at the El Gordo Radio YouTube live stream.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank. Players.
A 68-game conference win streak is on the line tonight. Two state-ranked teams battling it out as Bishop Garrigan leads North Union 31-30. The Golden Bears outscore the Warriors 18-7 in the third quarter to retake the lead. But Beanie, this is a test for the coaches as well. Garrigan doesn't play in a lot of close games, so the situational ball by Coach Schwab and staff, that's going to be tested tonight.
No, they don't, and I think they're having fun. I think they like these contests. I mean, this is why you play sports. You want to have great contests, get pushed, and Bartolo and Capacious still talking as they dribble the ball to start the fourth quarter.
Alish on the near side gets it to the high post to Capacious. Capacious had it knocked away. She picks it back up near half court and keeps it away from Stevens. Pass a little behind Alish as she collects it. Alish dribbles left of the paint, bounce pass towards Capacious in the corner. Capacious moving around. Eastman trying to post up inside as the Golden Bears keep the ball around the perimeter with 7:35 on the clock. Bartolo finds the cutting Capacious. Capacious takes one hard dribble, puts up a tough shot and left it short, and Miro rips the rebound away from Eastman. Jones will bring it across half court. Chance for North Union to take the lead as Jones has the top of the key. She drifts towards the right side. Ball knocked away from Stevens on the handoff as Alish defends. The screen by Walters. Alish staying with Stevens. And now curling around towards the right side is Ulrich. Ulrich drifting out to the right wing. Into the corner to Jones. Jones drives baseline. She got through. She reverses and she scores. What a play by Naomi Jones.
That is a shot you don't see very often in high school girls basketball. The reverse layup, driving baseline. Impressive shot by Jones. Put her team up by one.
A senior experience by Naomi Jones. Now Eastman driving in, splits two defenders, got inside and scored. That was too easy for Eastman, and it's 33-32.
You got that right. Eastman just easy to the hoop. They chose not to have any contact to put Eastman on the line, and she's been missing.
Oh, Merrill fakes one side, turns for a jumper, missed it though. She crossed up the defense but couldn't knock it down, and Garrigan still leads by one. Alish into the front court, passes right side to Bartolo deep on the wing. Looks to the high post to Eastman. Squares for a jumper off the back of the iron. Long rebound out to Montag. Montag to the lane. Hook shot up. That one misses as well. And Jones brings in the rebound. It gets knocked away though. It's loose on the floor. And a tie up between Montag and Merrill.
Awesome. Big rebounding by Montag. The long one comes out to her, but she went right back into the hoop and was fighting for that one. Now that jump ball created by Montag, that could come back and be a benefit for the Bears. The North Union has the possession right now.
Garrigan has kept some full court pressure on for a good part of the third quarter. Now to start the fourth as Capacious guards Stevens. Stevens will get it into the front court. Both Capacious and Stevens were on state qualifying 4x100-meter relays as the shot is off the shot clock and out of bounds for North Union. But some serious track speed on the floor between those two, battling it in the backcourt.
Stevens was determined to get to the hoop. She put up that high left-handed off the glass, but was kind of fading away, and it went a little higher than she bargained for.
Alish holds it on the left wing. Rotation around to Montag, right wing. Eastman back out to Alish. Releases a three-point try. A little bit too long. Capacious tips the rebound in the air, and she keeps it alive. She got it away from Jones. Sidearm pass over to Montag on the right wing. Wanted to shoot, but dropped the ball. And she'll get it out to Bartolo. Stevens jumps the pass, but Stevens ran through Bartolo for the foul.
Stevens saw an interception and a breakaway layup happen in there. But Bartolo did a nice job of coming to the ball and creating contact, and the official has to call the foul on Stevens.
5:45 left in the fourth quarter. Bartolo pulls up from downtown. Missed it a little bit long, though, and the rebound by Walters. Out to Jones. Jones striding up the near side of the court. Jones underhanded out to Ulrich on the right wing. Ulrich thought about pulling. Now she'll sidestep into a three. Left it way short. It banks off the glass and goes out to Capacious for the rebound. Abby Capacious, number two in the conference in rebounds per game. As Alish has the ball near half court for Bishop Garrigan. Almost threw that pass away as Jones tried to jump it, but Bartolo has it for Garrigan. Bartolo left corner, looks for Eastman in the post. One-on-one against Merrill. Eastman pivots. The help defense by Stevens and a foul. That might have been on Stevens reaching in that time. She got a lot of ball, but got a little bit of hand as well.
That happened right in front of the boys' JV team and Moore down there, and they are mad. They saw a lot of ball, but the official saw some contact and called it there. That's pretty good defense by North Union, Tyler.
Eastman trekking to the free throw line once again as that foul is number two called against Stevens.
You can see the competition going on the floor because of the competitive nature of these girls down here. Both teams, boy, these are people that want to compete. They're having fun out there. Eastman at the line misses her first free throw, and she's one of them. She loves the competition. I guarantee, but neither of these teams wants to lose this game, of course, but I think they all love the good game they're playing.
No doubt the competitive fire comes out as Eastman splits the pair, and Bishop Garrigan inches ahead by two. 17 points by Eastman and a 34-32 Garrigan advantage. Jones runs into Eastman, kicks out to Walters, right back to Jones. Jones looking for the baseline. Montag forcing her down to the line again, and she stepped out. Montag got her again, and it's a turnover.
Coach Tigges is furious because he's saying that's a blocking foul all along the way. He can't understand how his girl can get pushed out of bounds, and he's got a good point there on the official and is giving it to him, and Coach Schwab wants a timeout.
Oh, man, there is steam coming out of Coach Tigges' ears right now as he followed the official all the way down to the baseline, then followed him all the way back to half court to provide some input on that last call.
I can see his point because we don't talk about officiating, but, like, his player was driving the baseline, and she wouldn't have willingly stepped out of bounds without the contact from an opponent. So that's a understandable complaint there, as both coaches are now going to put all the officiating aside and draw up something good on their board. They both got the chalkboards out. They're both drawing up something. And this is where you get your coaching medals here. If you can figure out how to pull this game out, whether you're Coach Schwab or Coach Tigges, it is a tough one because it is going to be a battle the rest of the way.
34-32, Bishop Garrigan. It's been a grind so far in the fourth quarter as the score is 31-30 going into the fourth. So Garrigan right now have a 3-2 scoring edge here in quarter number four. This is an every possession kind of game. This is not the high octane game that Garrigan's used to playing. This has turned into a grinded out, every score feels huge type of game.
That's right. And Emmy Bartolo hit a huge three-pointer a moment ago. I feel like there's a couple three-point shots left in that Garrigan arsenal because they have not made very many. They're not going to stop shooting, though. They're going to stick to it. Someone's going to get hot here with 4:55 left to play in the game and a game this close. That's still a lot of time.
With still 4:55 left. As of right now, this is one of Garrigan's worst three-point shooting nights of the season, as they just haven't been able to knock it down. Eastman passes to a wide open Montag, but threw it away. The pass is wide, and it's a turnover.
Well, you can see why Eastman was excited to throw that pass. Montag was wide open for that three-point shot, and that was a good look missed by the Bears. And they're going to put some intense pressure on once again out of the break.
Orrick in the backcourt picked up by Bartolo as Orrick brings it across the timeline. The high screen by Merrill. Bartolo staying with it. And she'll screen again, maybe a little more incidentally the second time as Jones sidesteps. She's on the left wing looking for the handoff. Orrick trying to get open. And Bartolo face guarding her. A great job there. They can't get the ball to Orrick. Now Jones has to reset here at 15 on the shot clock. Jones near half court heads right around the screen. Jones slicing in. Sidesteps Eastman. Tough shot and she got fouled.
Wow.
Tremendous lateral movement by Naomi Jones.
You got it. Lateral movement was the word I was looking for. She was started out heading right and somehow managed to cross the entire lane and get to the left-hand side of the hoop and twist her body to get that shot up. Impressive drive by Jones. That'll be Eastman's fourth foul, I believe.
It is. It is foul number four for Eastman, so that is a big, big deal. Murphy is coming in as the first free throw is no good, and Eastman has to sit at least for a couple minutes.
Well, you miss Eastman's offense for sure and defense, but Reagan Murphy comes off the bench. She's a senior, and she'll play some good defense here for the Bears.
Second free throw no good. Capacious flies in for the rebound for Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears continue to lead by two as we tick down to the 4:15 mark of quarter number four. Bartolo up near half court, gets to the high post to Capacious. He drives in, kicks out to Aulish, rotates to Bartolo, top of the key, passes up the three for a drive instead. Right side to Montag, releases a tray, rattles it in! Zoe Montag with a huge shot, and Garrigan's up by five!
You knew there were some big threes left in this Garrigan arsenal, and now they put the pressure on and force a North Union turnover.
A throwaway by North Union. They try to target Walters in the corner, and the full court press forces the turnover, and Coach Tickus is going to call timeout before things get out of control at the 3:56 mark. We'll keep it right here. But boy, Beanie, that pressure defense by Bishop Garrigan, you've got to love it. They have tried to play a faster style. They try to keep this game moving quickly and force North Union to take it the full length of the court. And eventually you knew at some point a turnover would come.
Yeah, North Union's ball handling is good, but it's hard to not have any turnovers against a team that's pressing. And this is where they become so opportunistic, that Garrigan Bear press. Just put a little extra pressure on, and the ball sails wide, and you get a freebie like a North Union throwaway. But down 5 points, still plenty of time in the game. But Coach Tigges has to ask the question, how do they attack this Garrigan defense now? You've got Jones, you've got Stevens. They've been able to get to the hoop. And with Grayson Eastman on the bench, you got to think Jones and Stevens are going to continue to drive to the rack.
No doubt, get the ball inside if you're North Union. As we said before, this Warrior team, not really a perimeter shooting team. They're about 21% on three-point balls this year, 7th of 9 in the top of Iowa West. So getting the ball inside, whether it's by post-up from Merrill or by drive by one of the guards, that is going to be the formula down the stretch. And see if you can get Eastman a fifth foul as she gets back into the ball game. Warriors will go 2-1-2 here on the full court. Up to Murphy. Murphy pass knocked away by Ulrich and out of bounds. Ulrich was able to hit it off of Murphy, and Garrigan will not get a shot off that possession. They turn it over.
Good athleticism by Ulrich. She jumped up and knocked Murphy's pass back at her and off her fingertips out of bounds.
The inbounds play goes to Jones. Brings it into the backcourt. And Garrigan will back off and let her bring it across the timeline. Capacious will pick up Jones. On the right wing wall, there's lobs into Merrill. Got behind Murphy, balls up her hands low, and she collects it along the baseline. Kicks out to Stevens. The wide open Stevens ends up dropping the pass and picking it back up. Bounce pass left corner to Walters with 3.5 minutes left. Jones ball fakes, drives in right side, spins it up, spins it in, and drew the foul. She got a step on Abby Capacious that time, and it's a one possession game, 37-34.
Well, that was gutsy of Nomi Jones. Capacious is playing great defense, slide step and step for step with her, moving quickly laterally, but Jones gets the shot off, and it rolls in with a little more English.
Jones free throw. That one's no good. She's missed three in a row at the stripe. She gets 9 points, though, and it's 37-34. Garrigan's on top. 3:20 left in the fourth quarter as Bartolo brings it across half court. Tried to pass to Capacious in the high post. Got knocked back into her pocket by Ulrich. Now finds Capacious into the corner to Aulish. The shot clock went off, but I don't think it reset. Yeah, that was not a 35. That was not 35 seconds.
The shot clock didn't set, so the officials are going to have to talk about it, what they're going to do. I think Garrigan's going to retain possession of the ball. They're just going to have to decide, what are they going to do with the shot clock? Can you set the shot clock and just estimate that they had about 20 seconds left on that? I think that's what they're talking about right now. They're going to come over and try to work it out with the scoreboard, which, having worked scoreboards before, sometimes that's the hardest part, just getting that scoreboard set to where you want it. This isn't college basketball where you got a whole crew on there. We've got some volunteers on there doing a great job, and we appreciate their help. We got Gary Kinsett, Eric Deegan, and Matt Muller down there, along with Alex Schwing, running the board, keeping it all straight. And they are going to give Garrigan the ball out of bounds right in front of their bench. Alyssa Hoagland's going to check in while we have a stoppage.
And they say 18 seconds. 18 seconds is what Garrigan will have, and that'll be plenty of time. As, like you said, Murphy will go to the bench.
Interesting. So you're allowed to make a substitution there. Garrigan gets in one of their best three-point shooters in Hoagland.
Montag on the right wing. Pass to Aulish. Dangerous as Jones is waiting in the weeds. Into the corner to Hoagland. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Montag on the right wing. Montag will dribble left around the perimeter. Capacious screens. Montag bursting inside. Tough shot will pop into the cup. Zoe Montag with some big moments down the stretch. She has 9 points.
Unbelievable shot by Montag. High degree of difficulty.
39-34 Garrigan. Ulrich navigates the baseline. Bounce pass corner to Walters. Rotates it around to Stevens of 2:36 left. Right wing to Jones. Looks into Merrill. Merrill posting against Montag. Fades back. Jumper good and a foul. Merrill spun it in. It crawled the rim and dropped through. And Olivia Merrill, when they needed it the most, a three-point chance.
Wow, what a big shot by Merrill. Can she make the free throw and convert the three-point play? 2.5 minutes left to go in the game. 39-36 Garrigan lead.
Free throw, Merrill missed it right. Boy, North Union has missed some big free throws down the stretch, and they are down by three.
Oh, you see some nerves or legs or something, because their free throws haven't been close.
Both these teams are not having good free throw shooting nights, and Coach Schwab is going to want another timeout with 2:20 left. He'll take a 30-second timeout as Garrigan leads 39-36. Sabina, you're in the timeout right now with Coach Schwab. What are you focusing on offensively with these final few possessions of the game? Is you got to make the most of everyone here.
Well, I think Eastman's going to come off the bench right after this timeout, and I think he's going to power it inside. He's going to keep trying to get to the free throw line with Eastman. They're up 3 points. He's never going to pass up an open three-point shot. He just brought Hoagland in the game. Zoe Montag hit one a moment ago. You know, they're shooting way below their percentage, and if you play the odds, you can still take that three-point shot. But he's got ball handlers, and right now he's going to employ those ball handlers. Hey, be careful with the ball, because Stevens, Jones, Ulrich have been outstanding defensively all night, and they're going to be trying to get that steal. So be very careful on your passing.
And crash the glass. North Union is creating really tough initial shot attempts, but if Garrett can get an offensive rebound off a miss, the second shot is oftentimes a lot easier than the first one, as the defense doesn't have time to get into position. So Montag, far side, releases a three-pointer, and it's a little bit too strong.
Eastman did check in on that break.
North Union has Stevens quickly navigating, steps past Capacious and puts it in. 1 point game as Capacious flew right by.
Tell you what, a great shot by Stevens. She's got right, left hands, both good to the hoop.
Eastman in the front court, deals to Montag, right corner. 1 point game, Garrigan clinging onto a lead. Their 48 game home winning streak on the line. Their 68 game conference winning streak on the line as well. Montag right wing to the high post to Eastman. Turns towards Aulish. Aulish wants to drive, gets to the baseline. Bounce pass, knocked out of bounds. 13 seconds on the shot clock.
There's Alish seeing the future. She knows there's an assist there. She drives. The Eastman or Capacious is going to get open. But good defense by Merrill knocks out of bounds.
Capacious in the high post. Works the dribble for 11 seconds on the shot clock. Out to Montag with 8. Montag pivots and gets to the Capacious right corner of 5. Capacious directs traffic. She's got to create. And a timeout by Coach Schwab with 4 on the shot clock. Got to save that possession. Full timeout, Bishop Garrigan. We'll take a quick timeout as well. Back to the final 132. Don't go anywhere, folks. It's a one-point game as Garrigan leads on KLGA.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
One timeout left for Bishop Garrigan, two timeouts left for North Union. Right now, Bishop Garrigan 39 and North Union 38 as the Golden Bears have the basketball. And Beanie needing a bucket here. You don't want to let North Union see that lead again after trailing for this whole fourth quarter.
That's right. Boy, every possession is super important now. And with this, with little time left to go in the fourth quarter, neither team has many fouls. Garrigan only has committed 3. North Union only committed 2. So whoever's behind in the last minute is going to have to foul if they want to send someone to the free throw line, and they're going to have to foul more than once. Minute and a half left.
Capacious will be the inbounder. She'll lob it into Eastman. It's a little bit too high, and Merrill intercepts it. They were trying to get an inside touch for Eastman, and now here comes Jones. North Union can take the lead. The senior Naomi Jones awaiting the screen by Merrill. Jones will head right. Capacious slides the feet and stays in front as we're down to 120 in the ballgame. North Union can try for a big time upset on the road tonight. Stevens up top. She drives right. Stevens kicks it into the corner to Jones. 16 on the shot clock. Jones looking for Merrill. Merrill on the post against Eastman. Eastman to 4 fouls. Merrill puts it up, and she missed it. She missed it left as Eastman didn't foul.
Oh, Eastman avoids picking up her 5th. Great defense. She stayed vertical. Went straight up with Merrill after a nice move by Merrill on her footwork.
Pass to the left side to Alish. 20-second difference between game clock and shot clock. I should make it a 30-second difference. Capacious drives baseline. Capacious kicks corner to Bartolo. Catches. Releases the 3. It's good! Bartolo knocks it down!
Wow, Emmy Bartolo. Unbelievable shot. 4-point lead for Garrigan.
Desperation for North Union. Stevens, 3-point ball, left it short. Rebound out to Stevens. Stevens driving in. Her ball got knocked away, though. It's a tie-up. It's a tie-up, and Garrigan has the possession arrow.
Oh, Bartolo is pumped. She's yelling at everyone that'll listen to her. But the closest person was the official, and here comes Emmy to the bench. That was a huge 3-pointer, biggest one of her season. May have sealed the deal for the Bears, but there is time left for Coach Tigges to work a miracle here.
A 60-second timeout by North Union, but we're going to keep it right here. Beanie, you said earlier in the game, at some point, a big 3-point shot might decide it. Bartolo has made 2 3-pointers tonight, both of them massive. And you know what? Plenty of time left on the shot clock, but she was so confident. She said taking this open 3 is more valuable than running time, and she drills it.
That's right. There's no fear in any of these guards to shoot the 3-pointer, even when they've missed most of their shots tonight. That was created by Capacious, so credit her with the assist. Capacious had it on one corner of the floor on the right far side, and she drove baseline and drew the whole defense, makes a pass just over the outreach hands of Ulrich, who leaped up to try to block the pass, but it just went over her fingertips. It's a game of inches. If Ulrich taps that ball out of bounds, the 3-pointer doesn't happen, but Bartolo was wide open. Capacious found her somehow, and what a huge shot for the Bears here at the end of this game. And now we're in a spot here where Garrigan doesn't have to foul up for North Union. However, when Garrigan gets the ball back, they have to give 3 fouls before they can stop the clock.
And Garrigan can certainly run some time doing that because they have good passers and good ball handlers. So the Golden Bears will inbound. North Union full court pressing here as they will look to trap Alish in the backcourt. Alish coming near side. She almost got the ball knocked away, but this is going to be a foul by North Union.
Yeah, Jones picks up the foul there, but they lost 8 seconds. They got to foul 2 more times before they send Garrigan to the free throw line. So that was too much time lost by North Union. They got to foul quicker.
Yeah, needless to say, this cannot take 8 seconds. You've got 22 left in the game. Capacious on the baseline. Gets it into Bartolo. Bartolo bursting up the far side. Spins away. She's keeping it alive. Bartolo passes to Alish, and they foul her. She ran 4 off the clock that time. We're down to 18 seconds. That is foul 4 against North Union.
And this next foul by North Union will put Garrigan at the free throw line, but now only 18 seconds left.
Capacious will be the inbounder once again. As Senior looking to dissect the defense, North Union will mock guard the inbounder, but Montag pops open. Montag near side, Montag fouled. That one only took 1 second as North Union fouled progressively quicker, and Zoe Montag's going to be the free throw shooter.
Wow, what a finish here, Tyler. Go back to that nice look that North Union got to Merrill inside. She did a nice move. Eastman playing with four fouls, and it doesn't go in. That would have put them up by one. It changes the outlook of the game, and that three-pointer by Bartolo will be talked about all night by the Garrigan girls.
Free throw short for Zoe Montag. This is who Garrigan wants at the free throw line. Montag over 81% this year, although you really don't have a bad option on this Garrigan team. Really, all the players throughout the season have been well above average on free throws. Montag will try to make it a five-point game with the second one. Montag free throw. Montag good! 10 points for the Garrigan junior, and now North Union's got a rush. 15 seconds left. Here comes Jones. Jones off to Stevens. Stevens has to hurry. It's 43-38. Stevens right wing three. And it's in and out. No good. Rebound by Capacious. 7 seconds left and a foul by North Union. That ball took a peek inside, but the rim spit it back out. And Garrigan is going to hang on, Beanie.
Wow. You couldn't have said any better. I thought that three-pointer was in. It was halfway down the hoop before some mysterious hand got underneath and knocked it out of the hoop. That would have given North Union just a two-point deficit, but I don't know how that ball went out. It was halfway down in the net, and it popped back out of the shot by Stevens. Stevens created shot, but Merrill was setting a great screen there, as here's Capacious to ice the game at the free throw line with 6 seconds.
Capacious free throw line jumper swishes it. 44-38, Bishop Garrigan, 6.6 seconds left. Capacious with 11 points. I don't have a rebound count tonight, but I'd imagine she's close to double-double, as she always is, and knocks down the free throw. 45-38. Here comes North Union. 4 seconds left. Stevens towards the front court. 2 seconds. 1 second. Stevens will not take the shot. That's it. That is it. Garrigan gets a massive test tonight against North Union, and they hang on. The fourth quarter execution was brilliant. The clutch three-point shot from the corner by Bartolo. And just at the end, North Union didn't quite have enough. It was a great game, though. 45-38, the final score. A battle of two state-ranked teams. And, wow, Beanie, these two teams look postseason ready tonight.
That was a great game, and they're shaking hands with courtesy. But I'll tell you what, those North Union girls are not happy as they go through the line, and they shouldn't be. They played a whale of a game. They were up by 10. They almost had this Garrigan defending state champs. They had them on the ropes the whole game, and Garrigan sneaks it out at the end. So, boy, what an incredible game played by the North Union Warriors. They got blown out by Garrigan. By 20-30 points the first time in the season, to come around and have them on the ropes till the very end of the game. What an incredible effort by that North Union team. They're going to be frustrated and upset in that locker room, but boy, they should be proud of their effort there tonight. What improvement there by the Warriors, and a great finish by the Bears. A couple big moments, big shots. This was the funnest game we've seen all year, Tyler.
No doubt about that. We're going to let it breathe for just a moment, take a quick 60-second timeout, and wrap it up after this on KLGA 92.7 and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Wrapping up game number one of our basketball doubleheader here on Hometown Radio KLGA. And this is one of the best girls basketball games this gym has seen in quite some time. Bishop Garrigan fans are breathing a sigh of relief as their Golden Bears overcome a double-digit deficit and win 45-38. With the win, the number 6 ranked in Class 1A, Golden Bears improved to 18-1 on the season. Perfect. 13-0 in the conference. They now have 69 straight conference wins and 49 straight home wins. Meanwhile, North Union has their 8-game winning streak coming to an end, but it was a valiant effort as the Warriors dropped to 13-5, 10-3 in the conference. the scoring by quarter went like this. North Union had the 13-9 scoring advantage in the first and 10-4 in the second to go up 23-13 at the half. But Garrigan outscored North Union 18-7 in the third and 14-8 in the fourth. That's a combined 32-15 advantage for Garrigan in the second half. They steal this game away, Beanie. And boy, I'll tell you what, they say defense wins championships. This is a defensive-oriented kind of night. Both teams moving the chess pieces around with a great defensive game plan and making those adjustments. This was a great coaching matchup. It was a great two-teams matchup. A lot of talented athletes, and this game lived up to the hype.
Yeah, what a game plan by Coach Tigges there. He kept the three-point shooters for Garrigan off the line the whole first half, made their shots extremely difficult, and when they did get the shots, they just didn't go for the Bears. It didn't stop them from shooting them. They created some, and that defense continued. But, you know, Tyler, it's hard to play four quarters of hard-nosed defense, and you get tired. And those New Orleans girls, I think, gave it everything they had. You saw them tiring a little bit down the stretch, but, boy, they gave it everything they had. And Garrigan was able to create a couple three-point shots there in the fourth quarter. Montag had an open one, and she nailed it. And Bartolo had an open one in the corner, and she nailed it. If those shots don't go, of course, it's a different game, and that's what's fun about sports. Sometimes it goes your way, and sometimes it doesn't.
Bishop Garrigan did not have a single three-point make for the first 23 minutes of this game, but they hit some big ones down the stretch. Zoe Montag, Emmy Bartolo really had some huge shots. Scoring-wise, Grayson Eastman had 17 to lead the way. Abby Capacious of 12, Zoe Montag of 10, and Emmy Bartolo of 6 as the Garrigan leading scorers. For North Union, it was Ainsley Orrick scoring 14 points, Libby Stevens and Naomi Jones of 9, and Olivia Merrill putting 6 points on the scoreboard. And beating the other thing, too, what a great match for the post tonight. It was physical but clean between Eastman and Merrill for North Union. And you know what? There was some. It was kind of a different contrast of styles. Merrill just has these slow, patient, deliberate moves. She didn't really, you know, get Eastman to bite too much, but just these nice old school post moves by Merrill. Meanwhile, Eastman, you know, you've just got that high low action with Garrigan and Capacious looking underneath for Eastman. It was really fun watching those two post players go at it.
It was really fun. They're both very skillful, and you both have to get put a body on both of them, or they're going to get every rebound and they're going to score every time they get the ball. They're both very good offensively with their footwork and their finishing moves at the hoop. That's why it was so interesting in that second half. Merrill sat for a lot with a little bit of foul trouble. Eastman stayed in, and then she got in foul trouble. So, yeah, it was fun watching those posts not just play against each other, but seeing when they were in the game and when they were out of the game, what their teammates did. And Steinberg came off and did a great job for North Union. Murphy comes off the bench. Just really well-rounded teams that you can see they've worked really good, done a lot of good work in practice. But there was a moment in that game there where Eastman got the ball, and she went to the hoop untouched. And if you don't put some sort of contact on Eastman, she's going to score easy. And that was a huge turning moment for the Bears. I think that happened at the end of the third, right when they were turning around and taking the lead. But, you know, that was probably a decision of Merrill. Didn't want to pick up another foul, but then that really turned the game for Garrigan. They took that lead. And once Garrigan took that lead, boy, it was seemed to be all the momentum was on their way, the crowd and everything. And talk about some great crowds now, Tyler. There's some great, great, great crowds at work tonight in the gym.
What an environment and what a game. Folks, you've got the boys' game still coming up, and if we remind you, it was a classic last time these two teams matched up as Garrigan won 58-53. That's been North Union's only conference loss so far, but the girls' game is in the books, and Bishop Garrigan has 14 wins in a row now and win number 18 on the season as the two ranked teams battle out, and the game goes to the Golden Bears on a coin toss. It's Bishop Garrigan 45, North Union 38 as we wrap up the girls' game and move on to the boys' game. We'll take a quick timeout and talk with North Union head coach Alex Fisher after this on 92.7 FM KLGA.
We've got more Sports Club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions. Satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op. Delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
We get ready for boys high school basketball action right now on Hometown Radio KLGA as the North Union Warriors take on the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. And right now we're joined by North Union head coach Alex Fisher. Coach, first of all, thank you very much for the time today. How are you doing?
I'm good. Hey, thanks a lot for having us on, Tyler.
Absolutely, Coach. And it's already been a busy week for this North Union basketball team as you had games on Monday night and Tuesday night against North Iowa and Belmont Columbia, respectively. So could you just first start listeners with an overview this week for the Warrior basketball team?
Yeah, you know, some weather kind of pushed some games back, you know, but for the most part, we're pretty fortunate that we had such a crazy December, so we're not backed up too bad on games right now. But, yeah, makeup game with North Iowa on Monday. You know, went down there. They always play us tough down there. They're a team that plays really hard, and they're physical. You know, so they gave us kind of a run for their money early, and then we were able to pull away late and kind of keep a lead. You know, once we started taking care of the basketball a little bit and settling down. So a nice win for us over there at North Iowa. And then it's never easy to go back-to-back road games, but we'd made the long trip down to Belmont on Tuesday, and really happy with how we came out down there. You know, it's easy to kind of overlook opponents when their records aren't very similar to ours and you know, maybe the level of success they had. But a very young team down there in Belmont, and we got out big on them early. I think it was 30-2 at the end of the first quarter, and never really looked back. So a fun night getting everybody involved. You know, our bench played the whole fourth quarter. Everyone scored. Just some good quality basketball down there at Belmont.
Well, Coach, you have your third road game of the week tonight as you guys take on the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. Obviously, the second time this season seeing Bishop Garrigan as you played them back in December, a 58-53 loss. You know, looking back to that game in December, obviously that was the team's only conference loss so far. What did you feel separated that game from some of the other games your team has won in the conference?
Yeah, you know, a little bit of an anomaly just of how that game went. You know, Garrigan did some really nice things. You know, they're very efficient on offense when they got into the half court, you know, and kind of broke us down. You know, they shot, I believe it was 59%, is that what it was? 58, whatever it ended up being that night was pretty good. Compared to our, I think we were 28 or 29%. You know, so I thought they really did a nice job of, you know, we really pride on winning the paint battle. You know, I think we're averaging about 40, 42 points a game in the paint, you know, and only giving up about 24, 25. So, you know, they flipped the script on us, and then they can do that with their bigs. You know, they packed in a little bit, you know, made us shoot it from the outside, which, you know, is not our strong point, although it is getting better. You know, we were 8 of 33 from 3 that night, and, you know, that's normally not us. You know, we want to shoot somewhere between 20 and 25 threes, so we settle a little bit too early and too often, you know, and you'll have that. But for the most part, I feel like we've come a little bit better as a team as far as, you know, understanding how the game flow is going, and then when teams are trying to do that to us and not always settling for a wide-open three right away. You know, sometimes with our tempo, the way we play it, we're okay with taking them, but at the same time, if they're not going in at a pretty decent clip, we got to keep working the ball around. So, you know, we're definitely an improved three-point shooting team from that night, and we'll look to do so better from there tonight.
You know, Coach, digging into that a little bit more, like you said, 33 threes in a game is more than a team's generally going to take in a game. With that being said, though, I guess, what do you feel Bishop Garrigan's trying to force you to do offensively? And, you know, what do you feel is successful shot selection against the Golden Bears tonight?
Yeah, and that's just it. You know, we see that a lot. You know, we saw it even a little bit last year. You know, teams know we're very downhill offensively, where we want to get the ball in the paint. You know, I think we're very good about taking the mid-range 12, 15-footers, all right, or making the help commit and dumping it down to the bigs. So teams know that, you know, and they know that they got to try keeping us out of there. And I that's what Garrigan did really well the first time through. You know, we I think if I remember right, we took 27 shots in the paint, you know, and that's out of our 68, I believe it was, that's not near enough. You know, we want at least 60% of our shots down there. You know, and their bigs, they rotate the three bigs, you know, that makes it tough. So I think tonight, you know, it'll be a little bit more of the pull-up. You know, we got to pull up and take the 12-footer when we get them, and, you know, not necessarily getting right next to the rim with their big 6'5 guys down there. But that'll be the difference tonight of, you know, kind of still sticking to our game plan of getting the ball in the paint and scoring in there. And then at the same time, when we do drive and kick it, well, you know, I feel like we're a lot more comfortable now of shooting the three. And we get the open looks. We got to catch it in rhythm and knock them down.
We're talking right now with North Union basketball coach Alex Fisher. And, Coach, that Friday and Saturday was kind of a unique schedule for you guys because you played first against Garrigan that Friday night because you had an early Saturday game as you headed all the way to Sioux Center for the Arena Invitational. So that was kind of a unique schedule there. It was back-to-back losses for the team. But the good thing for you guys is they shook off those losses and they've won 8 in a row since that time. So I guess with that being said, do you feel anything's changed with this group or anything's matured with this group since that time earlier in the season when you look at the past 8 or so games?
Yeah, you know, and we talked about that. We knew that was kind of a rough, you know, scheduling how it worked out. You know, we were thrilled to be invited to play in the Tyson Event Center again, so we didn't want to pass that opportunity up. Unfortunately, the only open slot for us was that early Saturday morning game, and is one of those nights where we didn't shoot it very well against Garrigan the night before. You know, like I said, we took 30 more attempts than them from the field and had 11 less turnovers and found a way to loss, which I don't know if I'll ever be a part of a game like that again. And then we went down again, got down there about 11:30 midnight, you know, woke up at 7:30, 8 o'clock, kind of went through a little game prep for Elk Point, a really good team out of South Dakota, and just didn't really have our legs underneath of us. So we shot a lot better, but at the same time, we weren't able to kind of get up and down the floor as we normally do. You know, so we came back on that Monday, you know, took a nice break on Sunday and came back and said, hey, that was a two-game skid. You know what happened. It's basketball. It's tough to play 21 games to a really high level, and we're going to have three or four nights in a season that we just don't play all that well, and we got to find a way to win them. And, you know, we turned around that Tuesday, went down to Lake Mills, you know, and put together arguably or maybe our most complete game of the year, you know, especially in the defensive end, you know, holding the team, you know, that's scoring at 77 points a game to 43. You know, we found a way to win. You know, we didn't do ourselves any favors down there, missing some free throws late, but either way, we found a way to win, and I think that really sparked us and got our confidence back. And like you said, now we've rattled off eight in a row.
Well, as we wrap up here, what's the number one emphasis for your guys in tonight's ball game?
You know, I think we just got to do what we do best. You know, we're at our absolute best when we're out there having fun. You know, we're playing fast. Obviously, you know, we have a good scouting report on Garrigan, but at the same time, we just got to play. You know, and our guys got a good knack for the game, and they understand certain rotations that we want and don't want, and we're the double, you know, on the defensive end. But essentially, we just got to get back to always putting pressure on the opponent. You know, right when we get the ball in our hands on offense, we want to make them defend us. If we're 75 feet from the hoop yet, we still want to make them get back and be ready to defend us. And then when they get the ball in their hands, we're ready to put some pressure on them and make them constantly feel that our presence, you know, we're pretty quick on the defensive end, you know, so we want to jump some passing lanes and take some risk and then at the same time be ready to rotate. So I think that's our big key tonight is, you know, we know it's a big game. We know we want to get this one back. You know, we've been taking it one day at a time. And at the same point, we're finally here. We've got another chance at Garrigan, and we just got to go out and do what we do best and have fun and play hard.
Well, Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck with tonight's game.
Hey, as always, thanks a lot for having us on, Tyler, and go Warriors.
That is North Union head coach Alex Fisher with his pregame thoughts right here on Hometown Radio KLGA. Right now, we'll step aside for a timeout, but boys high school basketball action between the North Union Warriors and Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears is coming your way in just a couple minutes here on 92.7 FM and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona Tree Service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
Ready for a show tonight, ladies and gentlemen. For the second time this season, it's the North Union Warriors and the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. And tonight, it's at the Bishop Garrigan High School Gymnasium for the North Union Warriors and Top of Iowa West Coach of the Year, Alex Fisher. It'll be the five seniors in the starting lineup. Preston Guerdette, a six-foot sophomore. Daniel Fothergill, a six-foot senior. Daniel Fothergill, a six-free senior. Kyan Jones, a six-foot senior. Aiden Lostrom, a six-free senior. And Cody Ermiter, a 6'5 senior. This North Union team coming in at 15-2 overall, including 11-1 in Top of Iowa West play. Meanwhile, for the 11-7 Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, who come in at 7-5 of the conference, Coach Meister and Coach Freilich are going to bring out a lineup of the 6-foot freshman Michael Joyce, the 6-foot senior Justin Bauer, 6'4 junior Drew Mahler, 6'3 sophomore Carter Schwab, and the 6'5 junior Nick Lear getting the start. Beanie, it was an instant classic last time these two teams matched up. 58-53 as Garrigan defeated North Union at the Warrior High School Gymnasium in a very odd game, but one that Garrigan turned around a little bit in the second half, ended up winning, and handing North Union their only conference loss up to this point.
That was a big win by Bishop Bishop Garrigan. Very tough to go to the North Union Gym. They're such a good team in their house and be able to get that win. That was a defining moment for the Garrigan team that gave them a ton of confidence to go forward with the season, knowing that they are a talented team and they can put things together. But North Union has really, really played some great basketball since, knocking off a lot of good teams to get to their excellent record.
In fact, North Union ended the conference win streak of Lake Mills. It was Lake Mills' first conference loss in a couple of seasons, and the Warriors have won 8 games in a row, so they are on a roll right now at 15-2. But when this team's matchup last time, it was one of the weirdest games you will ever see, Beanie, because here are some crazy stats from the first time around.
Mommy, Tyler.
North Union took 30 more shot attempts than Garrigan that game, but still ended up being defeated. In fact, North Union forced 29 Garrigan turnovers, but still ended up falling that game, 58-53. On the Garrigan side, they shot a better percentage on field goals than on free throws. There were all kinds of stats like that from that game. So it was a game where North Union really just didn't have their normal game. They took 33 three-point attempts, which is also not typical. That game will not be replicated tonight. We might have a fantastic game tonight, but that exact formula is not going to be replicated by either team in this game.
Yeah, let me spit back that back at you. If North Union takes 30 more shots than Bishop Garrigan and loses, I will buy you dinner for the rest of 2024, Tyler. That is an incredible stat. 30 more shots than the other team, and they lost. Oh boy, that shooting percentage was clearly not there up there in the Armstrong Gymnasium that night.
And that's exactly right. In that game, North Union only shot from the field 28.4%. They were 8 of 33 on three-point balls. Meanwhile, Garrigan shot 59.5% from the field and only attempted 8 three-pointers, so they got the ball inside in that game. But it's a different formula tonight, and this Warrior team is rolling, averaging 66.6 points per game as the Warriors come out with their dark road uniforms, the green NU on the front, and the white numerals on the front and back. Garrigan with the pink out night. They have the white jerseys, the pink lettering and numbering on the front and back. Actually, the pink bear logo on the front as well. Is that midcourt? It'll be the 6'5 Ermiter going up against the 6'5 Leroy Forbesh of Garrigan. And we are just about set to go. A packed crowd once again. Biggest crowd of the season as both these fan bases have turned up en masse. The tip is backwards by Lear, and we are underway. Garrigan wins the tap, and they will head from left to right on the radio dial. It's Michael Joyce for the basketball with the Golden Bears. They've scored 63.3 points per game so far this season. North Union letting up just 44.9. They've had a stifling defense. Schwab on the right wing. 15 seconds into the ballgame as he surveys the defense. Guarded by Fothergill, the top defender for North Union. Out to Schwab. Rotates it around to Joyce. Joyce, top of the key, gets it into the post to Lear. Back out to Joyce. Joyce, catch and release free. Buries it. 3-0 Garrigan.
Michael Joyce, such a quick release. Touches his fingers and mounts away to the hoop.
North Union quickly the other way as Wallstrom gives off to Gerdette. Gerdette heads right around the perimeter and bounces the pass over to Fothergill. Left side to Wallstrom. Wallstrom at the elbow gets it out to Kyan Jones. Jones, the point guard, brings it into the center of the court in between the circles. Now right side Gerdette, guarded by Joyce on the wing. Gerdette pumps inside, comes top of the key to Jones. A patient first possession for North Union as we're down to 10 seconds on the shot clock. Jones wanting to create. He drives. He spins. Got inside and the layup bounces in. It's fouled on the rim and fought about it before dropping through.
Well, he hit the spin move in the middle of the lane and went to his left. Nice job. Nice drive to the hoop. Here comes Schwab, who likes to drive as well.
An elusive spin move by Kyan Jones as Schwab has it on the right side. Schwab gets it into the post to Lear. Faces the bucket, kicks it out top of the key. Joyce thought about pulling. He'll drive instead. Deals to Schwab near side in front of the Warrior bench. Down to our right. Schwab spins right. Passes to Bauer in the corner. Bobbles, collects, passes to Lear. Lear fades back. Jumper on the way and rattles into the cup.
Wow, Nick Lear really elevated there. Got way off the ground and shot that ball at the top of his jump. Over the top of good defense there. Off to a nice pedestrian start here for two teams that can really run the floor.
We are averaging 5.2 points per game for Bishop Garrigan on 49% shooting this year as Ermiter bangs his way inside. Mahler holds his ground. They kick out to Jones, left wing. Back inside Ermiter, knocked away by Mahler, but Mahler fouled.
Well, they're gonna say Mahler got him in the arm. Two posts in there trying to get position on each other. Ermiter, very good footwork inside. We saw that up in the Armstrong gym. And
into Wallstrom. Wallstrom in the lane. Wallstrom runner, good.
And I was just going to say, Wallstrom did not have a lot of points until the second half. He's someone that can also produce for North Union. He does it just there.
He ended with 12 points in that game. Like you said, much of it in the second half is Garrigan flipping over and back. Joyce crossed over through to Schwab, and Schwab was about halfway across the half-court line.
Yeah, the official right there at the half-court mark to see that Joyce crossed over. Schwab had 1 foot on the other side, and that's enough. Here comes Kyan Jones barking out calls, trying to set up an offense.
The Warrior all-time assist leader, Kyan Jones, is averaging 5.7 assists per game this year. Gives off to Fabio. Fabio in the lane. Got to the rack and scored it. North Union up by one.
Wow, talk about athleticism by Fothergill. He had some hang time.
Joyce weaving between traffic. Poke away by Gerdet. Gerdet came in from behind and sniped that ball out of bounds.
You know, there's always an adjustment from the girls' game to the boys' game to pick up the pace with the talking and the camera work. But, boy, with these two teams, they can sure get up the floor in a hurry.
Yeah, hope you stretched out that wrist, Beanie, because that camera's going to be snapping back and forth tonight. Joyce bounced past to Schwab left wing. Schwab across the foul line, jumps past the near side to Bauer. Wide open three-point try, and Bauer rattles it in.
You know, Justin Bauer does not always look for his shot, and he's got to have a high percentage. It seems like every time he decides to shoot, he does indeed put it through the net.
Bauer this season's 50% on field goals as Jones answers with a three of his own. They dared Jones to shoot it, and he took it.
Oh, we're in for another fun contest here, Tyler. 9-8 in favor of the Warriors early.
I don't know if you want to dare Kyan Jones to shoot. He's actually 40% on threes this year, but doesn't take a whole lot of attempts. Pass to Lear on the block. Lear off glass and scores.
Oh, nice creation by Joyce. An assist.
Here come the points. Fothergill, nice dish to Lofstrom. Lofstrom layup good. Lead changes going back and forth.
Boy, there's the whiplash on the camera as we go from hoop to hoop.
Bauer right side finds the cutting Schwab. Schwab into the paint. Schwab kicks into the corner to Mahler. Mahler squares for a three. Mahler swishes it.
Oh, everybody is hot to start. Here we go the other way.
Buckets for everyone. Lofstrom on the post. Lofstrom bounce pass to the cutting Ermeter. Ermeter scoops up a wild layup. No good. Ball deflects into the lane. Schwab rebounds. And Schwab maybe used the off arm there against Lofstrom as he goes crashing to the ground. Joyce gets it back to Schwab. Lofstrom catches back up to the baseline. Bauer threads the pass to Lear. Lear goes up a bit. Lear almost put it in, but a chance for a three-point play as he was fouled.
Oh, yeah. Ermeter on the other end threw up a wild shot because he assumed the whistle was going to blow, and it didn't. And then another whistle that didn't blow for the Warriors down there got their crowd, the student section down there at least, fired up. And Lear gets the call at the other end and shoots a free throw.
Lear, 8 of 27 from the foul line this season, knocks down the foul shot, and it's 14-11. That left wing did come out a little bit for Schwab, and that is what the North Union coaching staff wanted on that foul. Five early points by Lear. Second one is a little bit short, rims out, and Ermeter snatches the rebound.
Well, now Lear has really improved all seasons, playing some great basketball lately. Misses that free throw, gets back on defense.
Gerdet right side, wide angle in the layup, no good, and Mahler brings in the rebound into his body. Schwab crossover dribble as he weaves away from Gerdet. Schwab between the circles comes right wing to Bauer. Wearing that left knee brace as Bauer looks, finds Joyce popping up to the top of the key. Rotation to the left corner to Schwab with 3:56 left in the first quarter. 14-11 in favor of Garrigan. Bauer top of the key, looking inside. Takes one dribble, crosses over, kicks out to Schwab, left wing. Schwab rising for a contested three, left it short. Rebound Lear, reached above everyone, finds Schwab center of the paint. Schwab picks the ball off the ground, gets it out to Joyce. Joyce to the baseline, finds Lear on the pass. Lear hooks the shot up, missed it off to the right. Gerdet rebound.
A good second opportunity for Garrigan. Kyan Jones looking to push the tempo.
Jones out to Fothergill. He'll launch a three. He'll bury it to tie the game.
Wow, just good, solid play by both teams so far. Hot shooting, good ball handling.
Beanie, the Warriors have inched up that three-point shooting. They're up to 32% on the season. Much better than earlier this year, and much better than last year's. Gerdet steals the ball away from Bauer. Bauer trying to steal right back. He knocked it off the leg of Gerdet and out of bounds.
Oh, and Garrigan will get the ball back off the leg of Gerdet. Boy, Gerdet had a great second half up there in Armstrong. He can really score in a hurry. He's wearing a brace on his left knee, walking a little gingerly on that.
Gerdet was the leading scorer for North Union in that ballgame as he scored 13 points in that 58-53 loss for the Warriors back on December 15th. Bounce pass to Bauer. Bauer throws it away. Nemerson with the ballgame for Garrigan as Jones runs the floor. Jones takes it himself, scoops the layup up and missed it. The rebound by Grady Madden, who just checked in. And once again, North Union wanted a foul. Some contact in the lane, out to Fothergill, driving in, hanging, scoring! Daniel Fothergill again, and North Union takes the lead.
Boy, Fothergill has the hot hand, and we got a timeout called here. And they're gonna ask one of the North Union crowd members here. The referee didn't like some language heard from the crowd. And
they're gonna kick someone out of the game.
Yeah, he's gonna be asked to leave here. He's right behind the Garrigan bench, and the apparently being a little belligerent.
Oh, and he is screaming at the referee
He's still upset. Yeah,
they're bringing the AD over on the referee. Someone's getting kicked out of the game. That's that North Union student section right behind the Garrigan bench. Meister pointed at it. The players pointed at it. The Garrigan crowd gave a rousing ovation for that.
Well, he doesn't want to leave, and that's not going to go well because it is law enforcement night here in the gymnasium. And there's plenty of officers
around.
We've
got 20, 30 officers at the gym tonight if that person doesn't want to leave. let's go. Let the players play the game.
Yeah, they want to play the basketball. Yeah. Trayton Sink's going to check into the game while we have a stoppage. This happened in the girls' game. We have an unexpected stoppage, and then substitutions are allowed to happen. Interesting. And here we go. Bears have the ball, heading back to their offensive end, trying to score.
Stinky to the front court. Almost got his pass intercepted as Joyce has it far side. Joyce to the baseline. Runs into Ermiter. Ball goes out of bounds and last touched by Ermiter.
Joyce came flying in there. Ermiter wasn't even expecting Joyce to be there that quick and just kind of standing there. And Joyce ricochets off his body and the ball goes out of bounds.
2-point lead by North Union. Nemers is trying to get position inside. Schwab inbounding before 5 seconds. Intercepted by Jones. He knocked it away. Ball pinballs out towards Madden. And Joyce bats it back to Mahler. Garrigan saves the possession. Joyce on the wing. Launches a three. Banks off to the right. No good. Rebound by Fothergill. And here he comes. Fothergill up the near side. Striding past Joyce. Flings up a tough shot and put it in.
Well, Fothergill is on fire. Well, Warriors want to get that guy the ball now.
Daniel Fothergill averaging 9 points per game this season as he's already scored 9 tonight.
That was an impossible shot, Tyler. He just knocked down. Fading away from the hoop. Unbelievable.
Insane shot. Into the lane to Mahler. Went through his hand and out of bounds.
Now a substitution. They're going to get Lofstrom back in the game. Madden's going to get a breather. Everyone's getting so, and I'm sorry, Ermiter's coming out. There are some heavy shoulders right now. Lungs are going in and out because it has been intense.
And Jones will deliberately walk the ball across half court. We're already down to 155 here in the first. Multiple lead changes and a lot of offense as Jones drives left side, lost the basketball, and Jones will turn it over. Lear will check back in as Mahler heads to the bench for Garrigan. Golden Bears go for the two bigs, Nemers and Lear in the ball game. And North Union going 1-2-2 here on the press against Garrigan. Joyce far side of the court, flings it back to Schwab. Schwab bursting into the front court. Schwab running the right side. Schwab gets to the baseline. Schwab passes to Lear on the post. Lear kicks out to Joyce. Gets it over to Sink. Sink on the elbow. Lets the jumper fly, and he hits it.
Trayden Sink, nice mid-range jump shot. He's got that in his arsenal.
Fothergill again. Fothergill attacks. Fothergill reverse, and Fothergill score.
Oh, he is playing possessed. Oh, he's unbelievable right now. Fothergill to the hoop again.
He was a second-team all-conference selection last year for North Union as Nemers has it in the short right corner. Picks it up the sink, fingertip catch, throws it towards the backcourt. Jones getting back there, and he takes it. Jones will bring it to the edge of the paint. He'll kick it out to Fothergill. Looking to the near side to Madden. Catch and shoot in the corner. Grady Madden left it short, and Nemers rebounds.
Grady Madden, excellent three-point shooter. Here comes Schwab.
Schwab splitting down the lane. Offensive foul by Schwab. That's Fothergill again. Daniel Fothergill is making an imprint on this game in the first.
Wow, what a game so far by Fothergill. It's 20-16, Warriors leading. Nothing gets people fired up like a good charge call. And Fothergill pops back up and inbounds the ball to Kyan Jones, who just hustled for a loose ball. Right now, North Union getting to the 50-50 balls.
Jones brings it across half court. Lofstrom setting the screen as Sink goes with Jones. Gerdet back to Jones with 46 seconds left in the first. A 4-point North Union lead. Madden fakes baseline, drives center of the paint, spreads the pass to Lofstrom. Nemers stays vertical. Lofstrom has to kick out to Madden. Fakes left. He drives in. Madden shoots over Nemers. Madden missed it right. Ball gets tipped out and Joyce has it. Here comes the fast break. 3-on-2. Joyce down the lane. Joyce swatted by Fothergill. Oh, what a rejection. 25 seconds left in the quarter. Now Garrigan wanted a foul. Into Lofstrom. Lofstrom layup good.
19 seconds left. Joyce with the ball. 22-16. Bauer back to Joyce.
Big run by North Union to end the first. It's Sink. Into Lear on the block. Finds the cutting Nemers. Drops the ball. Picks it up. Puts it up. Bounces in.
Oh, great shot by the big man. He played great defense a moment ago. Now he gets the bucket.
2 seconds. 1 second. Three-pointer Gerdet. Rims out. No good. And the first quarter is over.
Wow. What a quarter.
What a quarter. A little bit different than the last time these teams matched up. A little more high octane tonight. It's North Union 22 and Bishop Garrigan 18 on 92.7 KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Security State Bank.
It's Start of the second quarter here on Hometown Radio KLGA Algona as North Union leads Bishop Garrigan 22-18. Are you not entertained, Beanie Bodie?
Oh, I am extremely entertained. That is such a fun first quarter. Both teams playing great, shooting great, running the floor. They tried to stay slow the first 2 minutes. We're very slow. Both teams try to be patient. But you were just trying to hold those horses into the racetrack, and they busted out of there and started galloping, and it was awesome. Boy, great quarter by a lot of guys out there. They look like they're in the third quarter right now. Both teams spent a lot of energy.
Cale Jones is the ball game for North Union, as well as Drew Henderson, as Cale Jones has had a couple double-digit scoring games lately, getting into the rotation. Hook shot, Ermiter rims out. Rebound along the baseline by Mahler.
Big board by Mahler after the Ermiter miss.
Out to Joyce, flings it over to Schwab. Schwab goes right side to Bauer. 20 seconds gone in quarter number two as Bauer looks. Bounce pass to Lear, top of the key. Rotates around to Joyce, deep on the left wing. Joyce gets it back out top to Schwab. Now to Joyce, 7:30 on the clock. Joyce wanting a drive, flinging it to Schwab near side. Head fake, starts in, and gets turned back out by Madden. He'll find Joyce. Joyce rising for a triple, and it's off the back of the cup. Rebound by Lear as he sailed in above everyone. The height advantage for Lear. It's Schwab driving to the bucket and drawing the foul. He took it to the body of Ermiter, and the first foul of the quarter by North Union.
Oh, hard to keep Schwab out of the lane. He's so good at driving to the hoop, picking up a foul, going to the free throw line. They got Lear back in the game. A good rebound by Lear made that possible. You know, Bears have a good 1-2 punch here going with Lear and Nemers. Nemers played fantastic defense a moment ago and got a bucket, but he's battling some back soreness. And so Lear and Nemers will do most of the inside work tonight. Amari Thomas is sidelined with a thumb injury.
Carter Schwab, good on the free throw. He had 16 points last time these teams matched up. As the second one bounces around and settles into the bucket. It's a two-point game as North Union leads Bishop Garrigan. Jones strides to the front court, finds Henderson. The sophomore on the right wing comes up top to Madden. Madden driving right out of the paint. Madden gets turned 360, turns again. Lost Joyce, jumper up, rims out, and the box out by Lear for another board. Out to Joyce, far side of the court. Garrigan trying to tie this possession. 1 minute gone here in the second quarter. Schwab, open, three-point ball, left it short. And Ermiter, the contested rebound as he snatches it away from Lear.
Oh, that was a big battle between Ermiter and Lear. Both really fighting for those rebounds.
Cale Jones on the drive, picks up his dribble as he bounces it towards the near side of the Wallstrom. Seven times this season, North Union has scored 70 or more points. You can see why. They've actually had two games of 80 in that 70-point game scoring as well. Madden left side with 15 on the shot clock. Looking inside to Ermiter trying to post. Madden drives instead. Madden fades back from the lane. Jumper will settle in. The friendly bounce for Madden.
Soft touch by the jump shot by Madden. Good scoring production from him. Here comes Joyce.
Bauer on the right side. Bounce pass into Mahler. Intercepted by Ermiter as he got in front. Snaked that arm in and was able to snatch the ball away as North Union's up 24-20. Jones comes left side to Madden. Madden in front of the Garrigan bench. At the 6:08 mark, holds the ball, has his side to the bucket. He's saying, who's open right now? He's going to drive it himself. Fades for another jumper. Joyce tipped it. Rebound by Lear. Lear long outlet to Bauer. Bauer 1-on-1 with Madden, and he got bumped, and he almost put it down at a crazy angle. Two free throws coming for Justin Bauer.
Well, Madden really hustled back. He was the one that took the shot on the other end and raced back to get back in defense and committed that foul on Bauer to prevent the easy bucket. Good hustle by Madden. He is tired, and Coach Meister wants a full timeout. Let's talk about this crazy game.
Yes, he will talk about the crazy game right now for 24-20 score and Bauer heading to the free throw line. Well, Beanie, while we have this timeout, I wanted to bring something up, but both these games have been so intense and so back and forth, I hadn't had time to do this yet. You know, we talk about Garrigan and North Union and all the coaching chess pieces they get moved around. Well, when you talk about coaching, Coach Wadley, the Bishop Garrigan football coach, just got a big-time award today. He was named the Iowa Football Coaches Association Coach of the Year for the A-player class. So I know we saw Coach Wadley here earlier tonight celebrating that award, and certainly well-deserved after that state title run.
Well, he's over in that Garrigan crowd somewhere. I'm trying to find him, but he blends right in. He just squeezes right in between a couple people, but he's coming to the game tonight. I know he's always listening to us because he sends me messages on things I should say, but why not? He's got plenty to say. Congrats to him on his coaching award. That's fantastic. And, you know, they used to get to play North Union in football, but that hasn't happened since the redistricting. So only basketball is the matchup between these boys tonight, and these boys get up for this game. I know the Garrigan boys do because I talked to them in the hallways, but you can just tell the North Union boys are up for this game. No emotions left unspent in this game tonight. They're all going to go home tired, and we are long way to go to decide who wins the game here.
The scoring very much outpacing the first matchup, as right now Bauer at the line. Last time these two teams matched up, Garrigan took 26 free throws but only made 12 as Bauer misses the first one. North Union took 8 free throws and made 7, but getting to the free throw line more often than North Union is a big key for Garrigan to win. When North Union has beaten Garrigan, North Union has taken more free throws. Bauer free throw good. 3-point game right now, and it's 24-21. Bauer of 4 early points. It'll be Jones bringing it across half court. Cale Jones, the sophomore for North Union. Gets it near side to Lofstrom. Now back up top to find Henderson. Into the post to Ermeter. Pivots away from the double team, and he kicks it out right side to Jones. Jones on the wing. Bauer right in his face. Bauer takes the pass away. Outlets up to Joyce. Joyce down the floor. Joyce wants to attack. Lost the basketball, though. Mahler dives on top of it. Madden in there as well. It's peeled away. It rolls out of bounds, though. And I think North Union touched it last, and they did.
Well, that was a wild sequence. Mahler hit the deck. Madden came in. The officials had to look at each other and say, who did that go off of? Sometimes you just can't tell. There's bodies all over the floor, and the ball's bouncing around. One thing's for sure, Tyler. You've got to have good hands tonight. You've got to take care of that basketball.
Garrigan of one player at each corner of the paint. On the inbounds plays, Joyce gets into Schwab left wing. Schwab driving down the lane, kicks out to Bauer right side, rotates to Joyce. Left wing triple, and it rolls off the cup. Kyan Jones sails in for the rebound. Jones across half court. As Jones wants to drive, Bauer stays in front. As Jones gets to the baseline left side, he'll back it back out beyond the 3-point line. Lofstrom posting up against Lear. Lofstrom to the baseline. Lofstrom hooking his way back to the lane. Hands off to Fothergill. Fothergill right back to Lofstrom, but Fothergill traveled. Is that a wipe off a layup?
He did. He shuffled his feet, and he knows it, and he nods his head. He was trying to jump stop, but instead he got a shuffle here. And Lisa Muller's going to save the day where the bodies hit the floor a second ago. There's a big old wet spot, and we don't need anyone slipping on that. So clean up that floor. You know, Tyler, you're the shoe expert, putting 1,000 miles on your shoes every month. These shoes have seen some wear and tear this season. You know, and you don't want to buy more than one pair of shoes a season if you're a high school kid, and I think we're losing some traction out there.
I'm actually going to dispute that point, Beanie. I think players want their parents to buy more than one pair of shoes so they can have all the shoes in the world.
You're probably right. I see Joyce is sporting some pink ones. It is pink out here tonight at Garrigan. Besides law enforcement night, we got pink and blue all over the place.
Nemers at the foul line, 15-foot jumper, and he swishes it.
Well, he is the money shot from that spot every time. He rarely misses from that little free throw line extended.
24-23 North Union. In the year 2024, the Warriors have not played a game decided by less than 19 points. But we might see that tonight the way this one has started off. It's 24-23 North Union. Lofstrom handing it off to Gerdet. Gerdet on the wing. He drives across the foul line, jumping in. Nice jump off to Lofstrom. Layup no good as it pops out.
Oh, big rebound by Nemers. Unfortunate miss by North Union. That looks like an easy bucket.
Joyce hopping into the lane. Mahler on the block. Now to Nemers. Quick pass to Joyce with the ball. Moving with energy for Garrigan. The handoff to Schwab on the left side. Bolted into the corner to Mahler. Looks and finds Schwab at the 4:08 mark of quarter number two. North Union still leading by one as Nemers is in the high post. Bounce to Joyce right side. 3-point ball, Joyce off the front of the rim and sailing in for a rebound, Cale Jones.
They're one and done in the last couple possessions. Good defensive rebounding by the Warriors, and that's without Ermeter, who's about to check back in.
Last time these two teams matched up, as a 3-point ball by Lofstrom rims out. Garrigan was plus 10 in rebounding, but interestingly, they were minus 5 in offensive rebounding. As we're down to the 3:41 mark of quarter number two. Tons of crazy stats from that first matchup. Joyce right corner gets it into Nemers. Deep in the post, layup no good. Ball gets batted out, and Joyce collects in the right side corner. Gerdet forces Joyce to the baseline. Back to Nemers. Tries again. Block, but a foul. It's Fothergill on the foul.
Nemers is such a key piece when he's in there. He knows how to play around the hoop, and he's got a big body for rebounding defensive, and it's really hard to block his shots because he can clear so much space. And while Fothergill got a lot of ball there, got a lot of body as well.
Nemers is averaging 10 points a game. He's shooting 62.5% on free throws, but missed the first foul shot right. Joyce will take a brief respite on the bench as Bauer and Sink check in. Lear also on the bench right now for Garrigan.
So we got Schwab, Mueller, Nemers, Sink, and Bauer for the Bears.
Nemers free throw good, and we are tied at 24. 3.5 minutes left in quarter number two. 5 points by Logan Nemers so far. Gerdet, left side, beyond the perimeter, finds the cutting Fothergill. Fothergill, left elbow jumper, and he buries it.
Well, he hasn't had a touch in a long time. He continues his hot streak. Boy, he is playing a whale of a game so far.
26-24 North Union. Mahler will get across half court. They'll try to trap him. Mahler in trouble. Mahler pivoting. Coach Meister's calling a timeout, and they finally get it. He's calling a timeout there for about 5 seconds to protect Mahler from a turnover. At the 306 mark, Garrigan will take a 30-second timeout as North Union leads 26-24. So here you go, Beanie. This is a spot in games where Garrigan has let it get away. You look at games against Lake Mills. It's been close before halftime, but Lake Mills goes on an 11-0 run against Garrigan, and the game kind of blows out. So this is a critical spot right now for Garrigan, a spot a couple times this year where things have gotten a little bit out of hand.
Yeah, well said, Tyler. This is a key part for the Bears here. And North Union expended so much energy in that first quarter. They score in waves. They're a big momentum offense. Boy, when they get rolling, they really start rolling. So Garrigan's got to come out of this timeout ready to take a good flurry from the North Union Warriors here. 3 minutes to go until halftime. I know the Bear defense is going to have to weather a storm here by a fast-paced North Union offense. But I think Coach Meiser, they just wanted to save that possession. Now they got a chance to set up a set play out of the timeout.
3 minutes left in the first half as Bauer getting poked at by Fothergill. He drives towards the lane. Ball got stripped away, but Bauer picks it back up. Tries to find Schwab, and Gerdet knocks that pass away. Up to Jones. Jones will back it out to the right wing. Flings it near side to Gerdet. Catch and shoot three-pointer, and he arcs it up the front of the cup. No good. The rebound by Ermiter and the putback.
Oh, the big man for the Warriors. Logan Nemers was on the other side of the lane, so he couldn't box out Ermiter, and Ermiter just went up higher above Joyce, grabbed that rebound.
Ermiter, some big-time production for North Union this year, 12.5 points and 7.8 rebounds per game, and a big putback to put North Union up by four. Bauer right side, had a little trouble handing up. The sink ball got batted away, and here comes Jones. Jones bounced past to Fothergill, slicing in, layup too strong. Jones cleanup, good!
Oh, here's that run by North Union. They're going to pick up the tempo. Garrigan's got to withstand this push. Now they're down six, got to stop the bleeding.
North Union of two buckets in about 40 seconds, and we're going to have another timeout by Coach Meister. Garrigan's going to have just two timeouts left, and like you said, Beanie, they don't let the momentum get away at this point because they've seen this movie before, and you cannot dig a hole against North Union.
Yeah, you're right. You can't fault Coach Meister for calling that timeout again because you can't let it get away here, and you observe that, Tyler. That's perfect. Hey, I got some hot news off the press. Some people don't like our shoe comment. Apparently, Abby Capacious has worn the same shoes all through high school, so there's one high school kid that doesn't want to get new shoes ever. There must be some luck in those shoes.
Abby Capacious is a different breed, ladies and gents. You can attest to that, Beanie.
Yeah, you're right. She is tougher than anyone we got in school, I'd say. And I know they're listening from a long ways away. Not Abby. She's here. But her family's always listening to us, Tyler. So shout out to the Capaciouses. And, boy, that was seemed like it was a 30-second timeout. That was supposed to be a full minute. So, boy, they're right back at it here.
Bishop Garrigan ready to go on offense, down by six right now to North Union. Warriors looking for win number 16 of the season, as last year they won 15 games, so win tonight would exceed that. Floater by Lear, no good, and Lofstrom controls the rebound.
Good look by the Bears, nice jump shot by Lear, just didn't go off the front end.
To Fothergill, curling across the foul line, hits the spin move again, rises up, jumper short, and Schwab snatches it away.
And his shot goes off the front end. Here comes Joyce against Gerdet.
But those are great moves by Fothergill. Schwab slices in. Schwab takes contact, and he puts it in.
Boy,
layup
bodies.
For Schwab.
The three bodies hit the floor with some ferocity there. That hurt.
4 points so far by Schwab. It's 30-26 North Union. Ermiter posting against Nemers. Tough matchup. Bangs it off the window. No good. And Lear vacuums in the rebound.
Yeah, Garrigan's got both Nemers and Lear, so they're two big men playing together at the same time. They're going to make it a concerted effort to keep Ermiter from scoring inside.
Schwab deep on the right wing as Jones creeps out to defend. Now Joyce in between the circles. 1:13 left in the second quarter. Schwab right side, flings it into the high post to Lear. Looks down low for Nemers. Nemers layup, good!
Oh, reverse layup. What a shot by Nemers. The big man getting it done. It's a two-point game. Good timeout called. It stopped the rally.
Ermiter was trying to front him that time as Fothergill heads left, deals to Jones. Pumps on the three, sink gives him a couple feet of space. Jones flings it to the top of the arc to Lofstrom. 48 seconds left in the first half. Lofstrom got run into by Joyce as he got the ball away to Jones with 15 on the shot clock. Jones will bring it back to the top of the arc. Right side of Lofstrom. Now it's to Fothergill. Fothergill driving across the foul line. Gets into the lane and he got bumped. That'll be foul number one of the quarter by Bishop Garrigan.
Yeah, and three fouls on North Union. After a first quarter that seemed like there was going to be a lot of fouls tonight, the second quarter has been relatively clean.
Now in for the Bears.
Golden Bears will bring Bauer in place of Schwab. And Schwab just picked up his second foul. And Jones will be the inbounder. Kyan Jones gets it into Fothergill, who hands it right back off to Jones in the corner. Heads right around the perimeter, now gets to the foul line. 15-footer Jones is short. Rebounds out of Nemers' reach, though, and it goes to Ermiter. Ermiter kicks it out to Gerdet with 25 seconds left in the half. And North Union have the last shot if they want. It's a two-point game as the Warriors lead the Golden Bears 30-28. Jones brings it back to half court with 17 seconds left in the first half. Right side to Gerdet. Guarded by Joyce, 13 seconds. Top of the key, Ermiter, or make that Jones of 10 seconds. Right side to Fothergill. Fothergill driving in, kicks it out to Jones. Catch and release, three-pointer, and Jones left it short. Rebound deflects around, it's off of Ermiter's face. He got it back, 2 seconds, 1 second. The kick out, the drop, and no shot getting off before the end of the half. Lostrom was open, but that pass was a little off the mark, and he couldn't secure it. And that is the end of a dramatic back-and-forth first half. North Union 30 and Bishop Garrigan 28 as we head to the half on KLGA 92.7 and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beich, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires, they're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission, to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of nine physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
As we continue here at halftime on Hometown Radio KLGA, the North Union Warriors lead the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears 30-28 in the boys' basketball matchup. Right now, though, we will recap the girls' game with Bishop Garrigan senior Abby Capacious. Abby, first of all, thanks for stopping by. Obviously, competitive game against the North Union came right down to the wire. You know, obviously, you guys playing a lot of blowouts throughout the years, including this season. So how much did you feel the team needed a game like that where you really got tested at the end?
You know what? These games are what prepare us for regionals. The other night at Garner, we didn't execute the way we wanted to either, and I told all the girls, these games make us better because we are forced to overcome adversity. We are forced to play with adversity. We are forced to compete when we are struggling. We're forced to keep ourselves mentally in the game, and I think we did that well tonight, and it's going to show in down the road.
Abby, you came out in that game, scored the first 7 points for Bishop Garrigan. Just take me through your offensive approach to start the game and how you guys tried to set the tone early.
Well, at North Union, they didn't guard me at the high post, so tonight we kind of figured they might come up a little more. They didn't. So I was aggressive at the high post. There was a few times I missed myself at the high post. But just coming out, we knew we had to be aggressive and just play as hard as we could.
You know, Abby, the first half, obviously the team had some issues offensively, just 13 points at the half, and you guys were down by 10. What did North Union do better defensively this time than they did last time around?
They just played aggressive. They played hard. They played harder than us in the first half, and that showed. But we made adjustments at halftime. We weren't going to give up. We all said that in the halftime. We weren't going to give up. And we came out in the second half, and we played much better.
Well, Abby, obviously in the first half, you guys didn't hit any threes, but, you know, your teammates kept shooting it. You got a big three-pointer there from Zoe Montag in the fourth quarter. Emmy Bartol had a couple big threes. Just speak on the confidence that you have in those girls to just continue to shoot it, even if a rough first half.
Yeah, that's the mental side of the game. When you don't hit a few shots, you know, you're kind of like, gosh, darn it, you know? You want the ball to go in. But for those two to stay in it and keep shooting and play with confidence, I'm so proud of them. You know, those shots are what helped us win this game.
All right, Abby, well, congrats on the win, and thank you for stopping by.
Thank you very much, Tyler.
That is Bishop Garrigan senior Abby Capacious here at halftime on Hometown Radio KLGA as the Golden Bears win the girls' game by a final score of 45-38 and picking up the season sweep over North Union after beating them back on December 15th at the North Union High School Gymnasium. Right now, we're going to bring in Coach Schwab and talk about the girls' game with him. Coach, first of all, you know, I talked about this with Abby as well. You guys have played in a lot of blowouts this year and years past as well, so the team really got tested tonight. How much did you feel they needed a game like that to see what they're made of at the end?
Well, I mean, now that
that you come out with a win, you like to be tested, but I like to learn on wins. I don't like to learn on losses, but incredible effort in the second half by our kids. I mean, it was unbelievable effort. And that was the difference. You know, we just had to get them to do something to think so they didn't think about all the missed shots and missed free throws we did in the first half. I wanted to change the entire aspect of the game and press off of a make or miss so they didn't have time to think about the shots they missed and they could just play the game of basketball. And that effort is one of the best efforts in 23 years I've ever seen in the second half.
Well, Coach, a great effort in the second half. Before we get to that, first half, obviously, Northview did some good things defensively, holding you guys to 13 points. What that they did was effective.
Well, I mean, I thought they did a nice job of, just getting it into a half-court game. You know, they did a nice job of breaking our pressure of, you know, we were just trying to speed them up to make it a full-court game, and they handled that better than they did up at Armstrong of just being able to beat it with the pass. And in Armstrong, they airmailed a lot of their passes and the press break, and we got a lot of easy turnovers on them. And they did a really good job of just slowing down and not letting us speed them up in the half court. And they hit some shots, and we hit nothing in the first half. You know, I mean, I don't know. I think we were 0 of 10 from the three-point arc and, like, 2 of 15 from the free-throw line. I mean, we're just – we've got to make some shots. I didn't mind our shots in the first half. We just didn't get the tempo of the game. That was the number one thing on our board tonight was the tempo of the game. We couldn't let it go half-court to half-court, and we were lucky to change that in the second half and survive.
Well, Coach, obviously an unfamiliar position for the team at halftime to be down by 10, but mm-hmm. Where did you sense the team was at mentality-wise at that point?
You know, I challenged them hard with just, I mean, we can't do anything about what just happened in the first half. I mean, obviously anytime you score 13 points and a half is a very poor half offensively, but defensively, I didn't think we were that poor a half. You know, I just didn't think we were playing hard enough. I thought they got to every 50-50 ball in the first half. I thought we didn't get any offensive rebounds, which we were a good offensive rebounding team. I thought they got some runouts on when a shot went up. Our defensive rotation, whoever was top of our key, did not look at the runout or hustle back. I didn't think our effort was there in the first half to be able to play the number 14 or 13 ranked team in 2A. You know, when you're going to play a good team like that have won 8 or 9 straight like they have and have really played good basketball, you have to bring it every second, not just in one half.
Well, Coach, that second half, you know, eventually some three-pointers did start falling. Zoe Montag had a big three. Emmy Bartol had a couple big ones late. Could you speak on their mentality where they're not dissuaded by a couple misses early?
You know, they kept coming in the huddle and saying, you know, the kick out when we get it to the high post, we were looking to flatten our wings down a little bit to get that kick out to the wing and corner. And because I thought they were collapsing a lot on Abby and Gracelyn inside, and it looked like we were trying to get the post inside out to Gracelyn of her to pivot and throw it opposite to the wing, because I thought everybody was seeming to collapse, and I thought we had open shooters. We just need to get the ball there, you know. So, you know, we just wanted to keep getting the ball inside out, getting it to the high post, letting Abby either create or kick out for the three and then dump into Gracelyn. But, you know, much better job.
Well, Coach, congratulations on the hard-fought win tonight, and thank you for stopping by.
Thank you.
That is Golden Bear basketball coach Brandon Schwab recapping the girls' game. We'll take a timeout and bring you the halftime, or the second half of the boys, coming up next on 92.7 KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona.
trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of nine physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
Getting ready for the second half of basketball action on Hometown Radio KLGA as North Union leads Bishop Garrigan 30-28. Warriors outscored the Bears 22-18 in the first quarter, but the Bears had a 10-8 scoring advantage in the second. And now we begin the second half. Boy, big implications in this one. North Union 11-1, right now tied with Lake Mills in the top of the Top Iowa West Conference. Garrigan right now at 11-7, trying to get a season-defining win here before the brackets come out. Bears head right to left on the radio dial. Bauer at the elbow finds Mahler inside. Mahler off glass, and we're tied at 30.
What a nice play to start out the half. Set play. They get Mahler inside. Easy conversion. Tied at 30, like you said, Tyler. This is going to be a barn burner.
Left elbow, Gaudette drives in. Got to the rack and spun it in. North Union is back ahead by two. It's 32-30. Gaudette was his first 2 points of the night. 13 points so far tonight by Daniel Fothergill, the leading scorer for North Union. Schwab deep on the left wing, the screen by Bauer. Schwab heads right, down towards the baseline to Joyce in the right corner. Elbow to Mahler, now back out to Schwab on the wing. Head fakes, drives in, splits defense, but the ball got stripped away, and here come the Warriors. Lostrom has to check the rearview mirror. Bauer almost stole it. Lostrom bangs inside, scores Andrew the foul. Chance for a free-point play by Aiden Lostrom.
Well, they are really good at playing downhill. North Union can really attack the hoop from any point on the floor because they are so fast. Kyan Jones can get to the hoop in a hurry, and so can Lostrom.
Aiden Lostrom this season, 62% from the foul line. Free throw up, and it rattles into the cup. 5-point North Union lead.
Yeah, and that 5 points came in about 13 seconds. They can sure score fast after it was tied at 30.
North Union's biggest lead tonight was 6 points. It looked like they might go on a big run before halftime as Joyce back cuts. Ermin Orsad coming, though, knocks the ball away. It looked like North Union might extend this to double digits by halftime, but Garrigan got it back down to two after North Union went up by six. Right now, 5-point lead, North Union. Gaudette underhands out to Ermin. Right side triple, off the heel, no good, and Schwab snatches the rebound away from Fothergill. Joyce up the court, left of the paint, deals to Mahler on the left side baseline, checks his feet to make sure he's in bounds, and comes onto the wing to Bauer. 1.5 minutes gone here in quarter number three as North Union leads Bishop Garrigan by five. Second match of the year between these two teams as Garrigan tries for the sweep. The two teams split their season matchups each of the past 2 years. Joyce heads towards the right side, rises for an elbow jumper, left it short, and skying in for the rebound, Fothergill.
Well, Joyce is instant offense. He can always get a shot. Bauer with the pick on the long pass.
2-on-2, Bauer right side. He drives in. Jones reaches in. That's a jump ball. Great hands by Kyan Jones.
Yeah, talking about guys that can run the floor, Bauer intercepts the pass, and he can fly. He can get up the floor in a hurry, but great hands by Jones. Hustled back and tied him up before he was about to go up for a shot. A lot of speed on the floor in this game, just like the girls' game. We saw some speedsters out there in the guard court.
And now Lear jumps the pass. It was intended for Lostrom. Runs the floor, sails in, layup good.
Whoa, that's bonus points. That's bonus points from Lear.
Lear of 7 points. Oh, and North Union turned it over.
Well, I'll tell you, Lostrom went to take it out, and he kind of fumbled the ball, and it went inbounds, and he got called for stepping over the line. And it was just an unfortunate, just an accidental mistake. He was just trying to secure the ball, and it kind of dribbled off his leg into the field of play.
Boy, in a game as good as this, you hate to see a possession go to waste if you're North Union. Top of the key to Joyce. Joyce to the foul line, now kicks right corner to Bauer. Bounce pass into the post to Lear. Navigates with him trouble. Pass almost got picked off by Jones. Schwab fakes left. Schwab takes one dribble and gives it off to Mahler. 5:40 on the clock, out to Joyce. Joyce, left wing, now corner to Schwab. Into the post to Lear. Spins from Ermeter and lays it in.
Well, great offense by the Bears. They got that ball in the corner. Positioned by Lear. Beautiful pass.
9 points by Lear, and 4 straight points for the Golden Bears, who are now down by one. Jones drives in right side, sees an opening. Great pass to Ermeter, and ball pops out of the cup. It pinballs around, and Mahler has the rebound. And then Jones almost rolled onto the back of Mahler's ankle.
Well, the Warriors can't believe that ball didn't go in by Ermeter.
And now Gurdjieff picks off a pass at the top of the key, behind the back dribble, into the lane, weaved by Joyce, layup no good, and the rebound by Schwab. Great transition D by Joyce.
Yeah, Joyce was able to elevate and change the shot by Gurdjieff without fouling. Great defense by the speedster Joyce.
And in spite of a bevy of moves by Gurdjieff, left wing free Mahler, and Mahler swishes it!
And just like that, Garrigan scores 7 points in a minute. They take the lead.
7-0 run Garrigan. That's 8 points by Mahler as Jones almost lost the dribble. Mahler this season a 34% three-point shooter. Jones passes up the three and it'll come left wing to Wallstrom. Underhanded out to Jones. We'll make that Gurdjieff. Gurdjieff three-pointer. Banks off to the right side. No good. And the rebound by Bauer.
Suddenly North Union Warriors ice cold.
Cold couple minutes here as Bauer collects the pass. Bauer tries a free. A little bit too long. And the rebound is boxed out by Fothergill. And Lear tried to go through his back that time for the foul.
A good position. Good fundamentals by Fothergill there on the rebound. If that three-pointer would have went by Bauer, boy, that would have been huge. That would have got the crowd going. Bauer doesn't take a lot of shots. 30-second timeout. North Union wants to talk about things here. They got a nice start, built a little five-point lead there, and Garrigan goes on a 7-0 run, takes the lead, snatches it right back.
So 37-35, Bishop Garrigan. And for North Union, boy, a couple of missed opportunities in this quarter that they're looking back on. One, they stepped inbounds and they're trying to inbound the play and turn it over. You had a couple point-blank layups that didn't go, one in transition and one on a nice pass to Ermiter. So North Union's left a few points on the board here in the third, and right now Garrigan up 37-35. They've answered a run of their own, and this is big for Garrigan because we talk about difficulty ending halves good. Well, starting the second half good is just as important.
Yeah, for sure. You know, and there's always going to be steals and turnovers in a game. You just don't want to have any unforced errors that give another possession to your opponents, and that's what happened to North Union. Garrigan taking full advantage. But another concern for North Union, as they've been missing some easy shots that I think they usually make, much like the stats say happened at their place earlier in the season, and that's got to be a concern for Coach Fisher.
North Union shot 18% below their season average in that game. They shoot 46% of the field, but in that game they shot 28% as Madden misses a layup. North Union really struggling to get the ball into the cup on offense right now. Schwab in the front court gives off to Joyce near half court. We are halfway done with the third quarter, and Bishop Garrigan leads 37-35. Trayton Sink on the left wing comes out to Weir. Goes right to Schwab. Top of the key, Joyce. Joyce dribbles left. Passes to Lear, who wasn't looking for it. Madden intercepts it. Jones will bring it across the timeline. Bursting into the front court. Takes it himself. Scoops the layup up and scoops it in. We are tied at 37.
Well, that was a more difficult shot than they've been taking. And Kion Jones is able to get that difficult shot to break the ice for North Union.
7-0 run over for Bishop Garrigan. Top of the key, Lear. Pestered by Jones as he comes onto the wing to Sink. 3:28 on the clock, quarter number three. Schwab left to Sink, looking inside to Lear, trying to seal off a defender. He catches, shoots over Ermiter, no good. Ermiter got a finger on it. Ball pinballs around as Nemers tried to rip it away, but North Union has it.
Good look inside. Way to get that ball inside. They got both big men in, does Bishop Garrigan and Nemers and Lear.
37 all, 3:10 left in the third quarter. Fothergill on the left wing. Fothergill attacking the body of Schwab. He's taking it. He's pivoting. He's fading and passing near side to Jones. Jones dared to shoot. He takes the dare and he airballs it. Lear in there for the rebound.
Boy, Schwab playing great defense against Fothergill there, that possession.
Schwab gets the screen from Lear as he heads right. Schwab diving in, dumps off to Nemers. Joyce almost fell down as he was getting the pass from Nemers, but he'll bring it back out beyond the three-point line. Near half court, Michael Joyce, averaging just under 15 points per game for Garrigan, feeds Sink. Now to Nemers at the foul line. Back to Sink. They're really respecting that Nemers foul line jumper. Nemers now a three-point ball. Banks off left side, no good. Fothergill with another rebound for North Union.
Nemers was feeling the three ball there. Doesn't go. Both teams starting to shoot a little poorly this third quarter. Could we be tired this point in the season?
Nemers 0-5 on three so far this year. Schwab intercepts the pass. Look out from behind. Here comes Gurdjieff. And a foul by North Union.
You know, Gurdjieff's probably thinking, you know what, I'll take that foul. I've got plenty of fouls to give this game. And if I don't foul Schwab here, he's going to go coast to coast and get an easy score here. And now Garrigan will be forced to take it out of bounds and set up their half-court offense.
So the Warriors bring Cale Jones to the ballgame as Wallstrom checks back in as well.
Lear gets a break. Mahler comes in the game. You know, that Lear-Nemers, both big men combination, that line has been working well for Garrigan. It's been able to play some good defense, and Schwab's been playing good on Fothergill.
Sink to Mahler. Quick pass, Nemers. Nemers soft touch and score.
Good ball movement by the Bears using the teammates starting to mesh.
9 points to the name of Logan Nemers tonight. It's Fothergill into the lane, hits the spin move, rises for a jumper, and it rolls off to the right side. Nemers secures the rebound.
And that is a shot that he would have never missed the first half. Just a game of hot and cold.
Into Mahler. This game played at a fast pace, too. That could be a factor as well as Mahler works into the lane. Out to Schwab with 140 on the clock. Schwab from way downtown swishes the three-pointer.
Oh, Schwab chooses his moments to play hot, and that was a huge three-pointer by the Schwabby.
42-37, Bishop Garrigan. Backing his way in, Madden. Madden against Joyce. Got Joyce to fly by, and Madden got fouled. Looked like it was Mahler tagging him from behind for Bishop Garrigan's third foul. That'll be the third personal on Drew Mahler.
Minute 24 left to go in the third, and there are a lot of tired bodies out there, Tyler. I don't know how they're going to play a fourth quarter on either team here. It's going to be wild.
The depth, very good for both these teams. The free throw is up and good, so you can sub in and out a lot, but everyone who's coming in has to run the floor for sure. But these two teams, two of the deeper rosters in the conference, as Madden buries the first free throw.
And every coach wants to have his A game on the floor at all times.
Madden's second free throw good. Three-point game, 42-39, as Bishop Garrigan trying to upset North Union for the second time this season, up by three. Schwab collects the pass from Joyce. Deals towards Mahler left corner. 1:13 left in the quarter. He looks for numbers in the post. Pass out of his range, though. Collected along the baseline by Fothergill.
Fothergill, nice steal. Was so close to stepping out of bounds.
1 minute left first in the third quarter. Three-point ball. Madden left it short from the right corner. And Schwab rebounds near side.
And those are the shots that North Union typically makes. Cold against the Bears both games this season.
Schwab has it back up in the left wing now, top of the key to Joyce. 50 seconds left in the third quarter, 25 on the shot clock. Sink finds Mahler on the right baseline. Back to the cutting Sink. Sink powers it up. He got fouled. He got fouled by Fothergill, who had the contest. And two free throws coming by Trayton Sink.
Good strong take to the basket by Trayton Sink against a taller player. He elevated, maintained strength with the ball in both hands, and was able to draw some contact.
Foul number two against Fothergill as Trayton Sink goes to the line, where he's 3 out of 7 so far this season. Sink free throw right down the drain. 4-point Garrigan lead.
Yeah, that's a big free throw by Trayton there, like you just said. He hasn't shot a ton of free throws this season. Big moment, big game, lots of pressure. Garrigan trying to extend a 4-point lead at this point. Can Trayton do it again from the free throw line?
Sink right hands the foul shot up and rattles it in. 44-39, Bishop Garrigan. Sink with 4 points so far tonight. 5-point Garrigan lead. Cale Jones of the rock. Bounce pass towards Henderson on the near side. Now it's Madden just to the right of center. Goes left to Fothergill. Almost threw that pass away as Fothergill made the one-handed catch. Fothergill to Madden in the right corner. Joyce for the closeout. Madden working the baseline. Madden trying to reverse, but he stepped out.
Oh, he claps his hands in frustration. He worked so hard, had a nice move to get to the hoop, and just nicked the out-of-bounds line, and the official was right there to see his sneaker hit the black.
Ermiter's back in as Fothergill is out for North Union.
Boy, Fothergill with such an incredible first half. Couldn't miss. Has not had his offense going the second half.
Sink right side of 18 seconds left now. Schwab on the elbow gets it out to Joyce. Joyce sees a three he likes. Lets it rip and hits it. Michael Joyce from downtown, and Garrigan up 47-39.
Just the net didn't even move. Joyce just drains it.
Now North Union 5 seconds. Wallstrom hands off to Madden at the foul line. Madden driving in. Tried to find Ermiter. He was open, but the pass is out of bounds. Deflected by Garrigan.
North Union is going to have 1.2 seconds, Tyler.
They've got to do it quick. Bauer's going to check in for Garrigan as Schwab checks out. They want to keep Schwab out of foul trouble as Madden's going to be the inbounder for North Union. North Union's going to spread it out, keep their players beyond the perimeter right now besides Cale Jones, who's at the left elbow. Madden from the near side baseline. Madden looks. Madden gets it into Jones. 1.2. Jones sidesteps. He tried to get a good look off, and it was off target at the buzzer, but would have been after the horn anyways. Garrigan with a late flurry to end the third quarter, and they take a 47-39 lead into the fourth with 8 minutes of basketball left on KLGA 92.7 and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
The Getting the fourth quarter started on Hometown Radio KLGA. Another instant classic brewing between Bishop Garrigan and North Union as the Golden Bears outscore the Warriors 19-9 in the third and lead 47-39. Beanie, what's going to be the deciding factor in this fourth quarter?
Well, the Warriors are all about momentum. If Garrigan can keep stifling anytime North Union gets some momentum build up and stifle any big rallies, they're holding a nice lead right now at 8 points. If they can take care of the ball, it's looking good for the Bears.
Michael Joyce hit a big three-pointer towards the end of the third quarter. He has 6 points tonight as he gives the rock off to Schwab. Garrigan heads right to left on the radio dial as we begin the fourth. Schwab dribbling near half court as the 2-3 zone defense being played right now by North Union. Joyce deep on the right wing, trying to shake loose from Gurdette. Gets it to Sink, top of the key. Sink takes one dribble and gives back to Joyce at 15 on the shot clock. Joyce finds the foul line. 15-footer, too strong off the back of the cup, and the rebound out to Madden. Madden with a little pace, bounces it near side to Fothergill. Fothergill pulls up for a three-point try. Wine drives it. Rebound's going out of bounds. Ermiter tries to bat it in, and that is out of bounds off of Ermiter.
Oh, you can see the right out of the quarter break, North Union starts to play fast. We got some good defense there, and then they tried to push the tempo, but Schwab and Joyce just high-five each other. And those two guards are going to run as much clock as they can. They're excellent ball handlers for the Bears as North Union tries to press them.
So Garrigan likes to fly around the court, but can they be patient here down the stretch? Joyce gets it to top of the key. Schwab, good look from three-point land. Too long. Rebound is batted around, and Fothergill bats it to himself in the lane. Kyan Jones into the front court, gets it left to Madden. Now Jones on the wing. 1 minute gone here in quarter number four as Garrigan leads by eight. Right side to Gurdette. Gurdette right of the paint, driving in, putting it up. Joyce blocks the shot, and Joyce saves the ball.
That's some athleticism by both those young men, Gurdette versus Joyce.
Now Sink the other way. His shot is blocked in the other end by Madden. Sink trying to save it. Ball loose. Sink rolls. He got it to Schwab. But that roll is going to be called as Sink traveled.
Oh, you can feel the intensity brewing here, Tyler. The crowd, the players. This is going to be a flurry of a fourth quarter.
6:45 left in the fourth. And North Union trying to get back on track offensively as it's 47-39. Warriors had a couple big offensive games earlier this week, getting above that 70-point mark against both Belmont Clemmie and North Iowa. In fact, scoring over 80 against the Broncos. Bounce pass to the cutting Jones, a little behind him, and Sink peels it away. An empty possession without a shot attempt by North Union, and Schwab brings it across half court. These teams scoreless for the first minute and a half of this quarter. Joyce on the right side wing, bounces it to Schwab in the corner. Madden almost at the seal, he shovels it in. Ball gets volleyballed near side, and it's heading into the scoring table. Last touch by Bishop Garrigan.
Well, both teams have ratcheted up the defense. The Garrigan defense has been so much improved recently here in the second half of the season. North Union's strength is their teamwork. They really move the ball around, but the Garrigan D has really done a nice job against it so far.
Onto the wing to Ermiter. Ermiter catch and shoot three, and it bounces off the rim, hits the glass, and drops through. Big shot for Ermiter.
Well, those rims have been so unfriendly in the third quarter. That shot bounces around the rim, hits the glass, and then goes in.
Ermiter has added the three-pointer to his game this season. He came into tonight 7 of 21 on threes. Nemers inside got hacked. It was Nemers against Fothergill. Fothergill singles for a jump ball, but instead, it'll be 2 free throws by Nemer and another personal foul, number 3 against Fothergill.
Boy, Fothergill. Good elevation, but he just doesn't have the size of the body that you need if you're going to stop Nemers inside. Good execution by the Bears to get Nemers the ball in that low position. Unstoppable from there unless you foul him, which Fothergill had to do.
Free throw no good for Nemers. This is part of what makes Bishop Garrigan a tough matchup for this North Union team that's been 15-2 so far this season. Garrigan just has so many bigs. That includes Nemers, Lear, normally Amari Thomas who's out tonight, and then Mahler can function as a big as well. Just, it's tough for North Union to match up with the size because they, of course, have Ermiter, but they're a little smaller after that.
That's an excellent point, Tyler. In all sports, so much about the matchups. This Garrigan-North Union matchup is an interesting one.
Jones spinning inside. Scoops the layup up and in. Crazy English by Jones.
Can I use the word circus? That was a circus right there. All at the thanks of Kyan Jones.
Circus shot by Jones. Lear baseline jumper. Pops out of the cup. Nemers rebounds and Nemers sets it in.
There it is. The two big men making it happen.
50-44 Garrigan. Now Ermiter leaking down the court and he got behind the defense for two. Garrigan not back in time.
Well, that's Kyan Jones starting to make it happen. That was a beautiful pass from Ermiter. From deep, Kyan Jones found his teammate.
Great assist as Schwab tries to spin away. Stolen by Madden, but he stepped out. Oh, no, he didn't step out. It was a foul by Schwab. I thought that might be called as Schwab had him tripping up around the ankles.
Well, Schwab getting back on defense, and that's what that foul enabled him to do. He gave up the turnover, and he prevented the run-out layup by Madden. And that gives the Bears at least a chance to set up their defense. So a smart foul by the sophomore point guard. And he gives a high five to Madden as they go down the floor. No ill will there. Some good sportsmanship always on the floor here.
On the left elbow, it's Jones. Gives it right wing to Fothergill. Guarded by Schwab. Fothergill heading right around traffic. Drives baseline. Challenges Nemers. Shot no good. Cleanup. Wostrom. And Wostrom puts it down. 2-point game. Well, oh, man. Nemers might be a little slow getting up there, or he just slipped on the floor.
He's playing with a sore back. He popped up a little bit. Schwab says there's a wet spot over there he wants cleaned up. Coach Brian Patterson's going to get out there with a – oh, no, Rob Meister's going to get out there with a broom. They're going to clean up some wetness on the floor where Nemers hit. Nemers is going to get a nice breaker. He's nursing a sore back. He didn't play at all against Garner Hayfield on Tuesday. Logan Nemers did not. It was all Lear and Thomas, and then Thomas hurt his thumb, and Nemers being a trooper tonight. And they – boy, do they need him, Tyler.
No doubt, and Mahler will check in for Bishop Garrigan. Well, right now, Beanie, it's 50-48. And this isn't one of those 10-0 spurts in 2 minutes that Northview can do, but this is kind of an extended gradual run to get back into it. If you remember, they were down by 8 at the start of this quarter, yeah. And now they've got it down to 2.
Well, I misspoke. Garrigan was up by 8, and I thought it looks pretty good for the Bears, but that is me not paying attention to how fast North Union can score the ball. I mean, they showed no panic. I feel like when the fourth quarter starts, it's kind of time to go, and they were just calm and casual, because I guess when you can score that fast, 4 minutes and 43 seconds left in the game like there is now is an eternity.
2-point lead by Garrigan. Every possession critical down the stretch. Joyce a behind-the-back dribble. He deals to Schwab on the wing. Schwab back out to Joyce. Just a step to the left side. Guarded by Fothergill. Joyce underhands it out to Schwab as Gerdet has him on defense. Right side Joyce launches a three. Rims out, no good. Ball volleyballs around, and Wostrom plucks it out of the air.
Well, Lear kept it alive, but Wostrom had a better effort there. Incredible rebound.
Coming down to the wire again between Garrigan and North Union. Jones deep on the left wing. Surveying the court. Jones backing his way in. Jones goes up. Ball got stripped away, and here comes Garrigan. Jones with a patient move, but Garrigan a good defense as Mahler spins. Got it to Lear. Lear inside. Shot no good. Ball deflects off the backboard, and Jones picks it up, and then he gets tripped up by Mahler, and Garrigan called for a foul.
Oh, this all kinds of action happening here. The FAR official says, I got to call something, otherwise it's going to get out of hand like crazy, because there's all kinds of bodies hitting the floor as Lear hit the floor, hustling for it. Kyan Jones and those two guys get off the hardwood and slap each other, give some fives out to each other. We got a lot of kids having a lot of fun basketball tonight, both girls' game and the boys' game.
And that is number 4 against Drew Mahler.
Ooh, I didn't even notice Mahler was getting in foul trouble there. He picked up a couple early, I guess, way back in the beginning of the game. But North Union will get the ball. They're cleaning up some more wetness on the floor here. You can hear the shoes squeaking all over the place tonight.
I'll tell you what, Bean, everyone's sweating here. I'm sweating. There's just so many people in this gym tonight. This crowd is packed, as we said. And
well, I'll tell you, it was 40 below last week. We heated up the building, and now we can't cool it back down. Now it's 40 outside.
That's a distant memory right now, as a timeout is called by Coach Alex Fisher for North Union. A 60-second timeout that we will take of Coach Fisher on 92.7 KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center. Make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Sweaty palms time here at the Bishop Garrigan High School Gymnasium. Golden Bears lead North Union by 2 as the Warriors have the rock right now. Jones getting open. Jones driving in. Tried to dump it off the Fothergill. Knocked away. Jones got it back. Jones along the baseline. And a push called against Bishop Garrigan for their third foul. Looked to be Lear on that one, and it was.
Boy, Jones is working hard down there. He drove in, and he was looking for an interior pass. And he got all the way, got double teamed by Mueller and Lear. And that's a hard double team to get out of. Those guys are huge. And Kyan Jones... tried to find someone inside, ends up getting pushed out of bounds. And when he hit the floor, since these guys, man, these guys are putting a lot of effort in. Everybody is drenched in sweat. And every time a body hits the floor, it's like someone threw a pitcher of water out there on the hardwood.
Yes, here comes the towels, and here comes the floor sweeper again. Those things are going to be moist or even drenched by the end of tonight with all the sweat that's on the floor right now, Beanie.
It is going to be drenched. I think it's a waterfall going down out there. I think they're going to have to grab the mascot and just use him to mop up the water.
Oh, you wouldn't do that to Gary the Bear, would you?
He's got a brand new jersey on tonight. we're splurging on a bear jersey.
Right of the lane, Madden. Madden drug the back foot, and he traveled.
Oh, he's frustrated. He almost spiked the ball in frustration and thought better of it. Wise move, young man. You don't want to pick up a technical foul just because you're frustrated this travel, but I do feel bad for him. That foot drug, and he didn't mean to.
All right, well, Gary the Bear, stay far away from Beanie Bodie when this game wraps up as, Schwab snatched the ball away from Fothergill, nearly a steal. Mahler left corner, free ball too strong. Rebound by Weir, the kick out to Schwab, and Garrigan can reset. Schwab will take a three instead, it's short, and Schwab followed his miss. Ball pinballs around, Schwab had it briefly. Weir saves it, throws it to Joyce, and Garrigan has it. A tight rope act along the sideline. Schwab on the left side with 3:09 on the clock. Right to Joyce on the wing. Gaudette runs at him, top of the key, Schwab, head fakes. Gets it right side to Joyce, into the post towards Lear, knocked away. A steal by Fothergill on a big-time steal at that.
That was a big-time steal. Garrigan got two more looks thanks to some great offensive rebounding by Lear. But the poke away, here comes Gaudette.
Gaudette head fakes, gets it into the corner to Fothergill as Joyce defends. Fothergill backing his way in, sidearm pass out to the corner. Gaudette arcs up a three, left a little short, and Lear flies in for the rebound of 2:41 left.
Another rebound by Lear. Boy, he's been huge lately. Two-point game.
North Union has outscored Bishop Garrigan here in the fourth quarter, 9-3 so far. We're down to 2:30 left. Garrigan's 8-point lead is down to 2. Joyce in the high post. Joyce, 10-footer. It'll pop out. Lear rebounded. Lear got fouled. A huge pour by Nick Lear. And boy, Garrigan is really hurting North Union on the offensive glass tonight. That may be the number one differentiator right now.
For sure. And a lot of it is Nick Lear, also Logan Nemers. But Lear has gotten 5 consecutive rebounds. Even if they have him boxed out, he's able to jump up, give some push, and get up there and get that ball. He's really rebounding hard. And now they're going to give him some help with Nemers is coming back in as well for Muller.
Nemers is coming in. Garrigan's going to turn up the rebounding.
Yeah, so if North Union's going to get a rebound, they're really going to have to earn it because Garrigan has got some size in there.
Well, it looks like they're saying no shots on that one because they're wiping up the floor right now, but they're also getting ready to have Garrigan run an inbound play. So they're going to say Lear was not putting that ball back, and that's something that he appears to be disputing right now.
Well, he knows he was going to shoot it, but when he got tied up and fouled or whatever, he had the ball down below his waist. So I guess the officials are saying you couldn't guarantee that you were going back up. But, I mean, he knew he was going back up. As we've seen Nick Lear, he doesn't like to give up the ball. If he's got it in the paint, he's going to convert.
He's ready to score. Lob into Lear, catches in the paint, hooks it up, missed it off to the right, and a big rebound by Fothergill, who's getting in there and battling with the Garrigan Biggs. Jones engineering the offense for North Union. Hands off to Gaudette on the left wing. 2:11 left in the game. Pass to Madden, knocked away by Lear, and Lear collects it. Big turnover forced. Outlet up to Joyce. Joyce got stripped by Madden. What a steal by Grady Madden. Here he comes. Madden jumping and passing out to Gaudette. Head fakes, drives baseline, and he'll bring it back out with 1:57 left and a 2-point lead by Bishop Garrigan.
Well, Gaudette had a wide open three, Tyler. He didn't want to take it. Who's going to shoot for North Union here, if not Gaudette?
Gaudette's almost a 38% three-point shooter this year, so he'd be the guy to take it.
Yeah, he had a wide open look there, and Coach Fisher is imploring his team to move.
Crowd imploring defense in the background. Gaudette, right side. Gaudette drives in, soft touch, no good on the layup. Nemers rebound, his pass knocked away and taken by Lear, and then a foul. Gaudette fouled Lear. Boy, that was nearly a steal off the Nemers pass. North Union almost had the turnover, and then a foul way away from the basket by North Union. Gaudette picking that one up.
They're going to get Lofstrom in. They might have fouled there just because they don't want to be in the same situation that the girls were in with less than a minute to go. A minute and a half right now, but they don't want to be stuck having to foul here and run out of time here because Garrigan does have the 2-point lead and North Union's at 3 fouls. That means 2 before Garrigan shoots free throws.
1:25 left in the ballgame as Garrigan continues to lead by 2. Joyce angles into the front court. Pass to Mahler. Intercepted by Kyan Jones. Here comes Jones up the far side. Jones, pass to Fothergill. Wide open and he lays it in. We are tied at 50.
Oh, players picking themselves off the floor, and we want a timeout here to clean the floor. Joyce is walking gingerly as he gets up. He just tried to draw a charge, but Kyan Jones slammed on the brakes and decided to pass the assist, but there was still some contact there. What a play.
Kyan Jones is uncanny. He exactly knows where the ball is supposed to go every time. That was a beautiful play. He knew it was 2-on-1. Joyce had to stop the ball, so he stopped Jones, and then Fothergill's wide open on the other block.
Yeah, great assist by Jones and great decision. I think if Jones goes up for that shot, it's going to be a charge because Joyce was set up there and tried to draw the charge, but just a great decision by Jones to pass it and not pick up the charge there. So now it's crunch time here, down to around a minute left. Tie game. Boy, Tyler, we've had the benefit of watching two incredible games. Come what may, it has been a fun night of basketball, and I don't envy those coaches right now because you can plan and plan and plan and plan, but I don't think any of them have any idea how this is going to play out.
The score of this game was 22-18 at the end of the first quarter. It looked like it was going to be a track meet offensively, but the two teams, they've turned up the defense. Fatigue has taken hold a little bit as well, and some of the crazy shots from the first quarter aren't going down anymore. But in any case, absolutely entertaining game. This has already topped the first game, regardless of how this turns out. And that game was a classic as well.
Well, it's been a roller coaster of shooting percentages. At first, teams are both blazingly hot, and then everyone goes ice cold, and then they're hot again, and right now we're in a cold stretch. Neither team seems to really want to take a shot. Nobody wants to be that guy that misses a shot, but you can't have that attitude. You have to shoot with confidence, especially at points of this like in the game. A minute eight left. Schwab's taking it out for the Bears. He's always got the confidence. He's a gamer. He loves to compete.
Now it's Joyce jumping and passing to Schwab. Jones is getting ready to undercut it, and a blocking foul by Kyan Jones as Schwab runs into him and the two pat each other on the back.
Yeah, that's why it's really fun to watch Schwab especially. Like, he just really, really enjoys the competition. But he's a sportsman throughout. You see him smiling through the game, and he's always quick to help guys up, and fives for everybody.
Joyce collects the inbounds pass. Now the North Union crowd calling for defense. Great environment tonight as Schwab has it between the circles. Lear to Joyce. Joyce underneath to Nemers. Nemers double teamed. He kicks it out, but he threw it right to Gerdet. 47 seconds left, and North Union can take the lead. And Coach Fisher is calling for a timeout. And now he changes his mind. He changes his mind. He's with the ball right now, Kyan Jones. Jones down in the right corner, 37 seconds left, and he'll bring it back out.
They're going to try to run the shot clock all the way down if they can.
Jones is taking it against Sink. Outside to Fothergill. Fothergill slicing in. Underhand to Ermiter. Wide open free. And it bounces off. No good. Rebound loose. Lear has it and got it off to Joyce. Up to Schwab with 22 seconds. Schwab barreling ahead of 20. Schwab inside. Layup no good. Oh, man. Schwab missed it. Nemers rebound. Put back no good. Batted out and Jones has it. 13 seconds left. Here comes Kyan Jones. Jones is the front court. Kicks it out. Gerdet. Three-point ball. He got it. 5 seconds left. Preston Gerdet from downtown. Time out, Bishop Garrigan. A clutch three-pointer by the senior who's being mauled by his teammates down to our right.
What a moment. The whole North Union side of the gym just leapt off the bleachers. You probably can't see it on the live stream. Everyone's on their feet. The Garrigan side hits the deck. What a shot by Gerdet. I complained a moment ago. He passed up a wide-open three. I didn't think he had the confidence to take it. He had to take that shot. Time is ticking down, and the senior has enough arch on that to get out of the gymnasium, and it comes down and swishes through the net. Unbelievable shot by Gerdet. Wow, I think that's the first three-point shot of the day. What a moment for the senior there. And Garrigan's going to convert to a full timeout. Give us a chance to catch our breath, Tyler.
And to elevate the camera, this is going to be an intense final, I think 2.9 seconds. They took it off the scoreboard when the timeout was called. But all right, well, Garrigan, no timeouts left. Garrigan has to have it. And really no time left for anything but a quick shot.
Well, what a sequence that led to that three-point shot, because Carter Schwab had the ball in the open floor, and he was going to coast to coast. And Tyler, we've seen it all year. He is hard to stop on the way to the hoop. He gets all the way to the rack. He goes up strong. There's no call situation. Lots of contact down there. No call. It's a battle for the rebound. The last two rebounding battles were crazy. Lear came down with a defensive rebound, fighting for it. A lot of contact. Went for the other end. Lots of contact. These officials are letting him play, and I wouldn't have it any other way.
Absolutely. Man, tightly officiated, or well-officiated game tonight, I should say, letting them play between these two teams. And we know how physical it gets sometimes. We know how intense it gets sometimes when these teams match up. But this game has been a joy to watch so far. And now, does Garrigan have any magic with under 3 seconds left?
Now, Garrigan had almost the exact same situation at Garner the other day. It didn't work out. Let's see if they fix it and can pull it off here.
Here is Drew Mahler. Mahler playing quarterback from the baseline into Joyce. Joyce lost the ball, picks it back up. Joyce, half court heave of the corn. It's no good. It's no good. North Union survives on the road. 53-50 Warriors as Preston Gaudet is a hero. And the half court shot by Joyce, no good at the buzzer.
Wow. There is one really happy team and one really upset team, and that's the way you want it in a good competition, a good competitive game between both these teams. It's going to burn a little bit from the Bears because they played another whale of a game against the North Union team. They got them up there in Armstrong, but the North Union Warriors prevailed the second time around in another close game, just a 3 points dividing these two teams in the counties.
North Union locks down Bishop Garrigan in the fourth quarter and holds the Golden Bears to just 3 fourth-quarter points after the Golden Bears have taken an 8-point lead heading into the fourth. A heartbreaker for Bishop Garrigan and potentially a season-defining win for North Union, who improves to 16-2 overall, and more importantly, 12-1 in the top of Iowa West. Garrigan falls to 11-8. They are now 7-6 in conference play. We will step aside for a timeout, wrap it up after this on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires, they're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
The broadcast up here on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream as the North Union Warriors survive at the very end. It was a clutch 3-point ball by the senior Preston Gaudet. He took it with no hesitation and made it with 2.9 seconds left. Garrigan got a half-court heave off of the buzzer, but it was too high off the shot clock, and the game ends in a 53-50 North Union win. The final scoring by quarter looked like this. It was 22-18 at North Union after one. The Bears outscored the Warriors 10-8 in the second quarter, taking a 30-28 deficit for the Golden Bears into halftime. It was a big third quarter for Garrigan. They outscored North Union 19-9, going up by 8 going into the fourth, but the Warriors had a 14-3 advantage in the final corner. Being able to start with the defense, because, you know, we talk about offense and the game plan for that and how you get a good final shot off, but North Union's defense, tremendous in the fourth quarter, and that is what won them this game.
For sure, and both these teams are offenses that can regularly put up 70 points a game when they're on, but the defense that both teams have come out with, Garrigan's defense has been stellar lately, and North Union's tonight was so intense when they needed it to be. They were really able to ratchet up the pressure and create some turnovers and steals when they absolutely needed them. You know, Garrigan, nice job handling the ball all night, but eventually you're going to give up a few turnovers here and there. And, boy, North Union got a couple when they needed them, one at the very end there. Garrigan got a look inside to Nemers, and he tried to kick it back out, and I think it was Kyan Jones got a steal, and that was just a huge moment, a big turnaround. And, yeah, that defense was pretty impressive for both teams, but North Union got theirs when they needed it, which was impressive because, boy, those guys were gassed.
No doubt about that. They were gassed at the end. And, man, Garrigan throughout that fourth quarter held the lead for most of the quarter, but offensively things just dried up a little bit for them. Some big three-point shots during the third quarter we saw. Joyce hit a couple big threes. Schwamm had a big three during that third quarter, but the outside shooting just didn't drop for Garrigan in the fourth. And then, you know, really there were a couple times where Lear and Nemerger got touches in the post, but there were a couple point-blank misses as well for Garrigan. So I think a few opportunities offensively that they would like to look back on and change.
Yeah, but I think it was a great adjustment by the Garrigan coaches when they had Nemers and Lear in at the same time and things were really going well, and then they went back to it, and that seemed to be a great advantage because Garrigan dominated the boards in the second half. Ermerder and Lostrom and Fothergill, boy, they can really battle on the boards, but Garrigan with Nemers and Lear in there were really able to clean up the glass there and prevent any second opportunities. And North Union is fantastic passing interior. Like, they can really drive and dish with the best of them. But having Lear and Nemers in there, it creates a lot of body mass that they have to try to work around. And that was a really good advantage for the Bears, I thought, in the second half that the Garrigan coaches went to.
And that kind of leads me to my next point, Beanie, because I'm going to say this year especially, and really this year specifically, because North Union, they're now 16-2. Garrigan has really created some awkward matchups for them this year. You know, this is a North Union team that has pretty much blown out every team so far in 2024. All their wins prior to tonight in this calendar year had been by 19 points or more. And, you know, their only conference loss previously been a close game against Garrigan, 58-53. They nearly dropped this one tonight. You know, in the course of a season, you look at all the teams in the conference and say, well, Team A doesn't necessarily match up as well against Team B, even though Team A may have the better record. And I think Garrigan is just a really tough matchup for North Union, but it really said a lot about where the Warrior team is at right now and where they've come since the past couple of years. They were able to finish out this game in spite of that adversity.
It is a really interesting matchup, and part of the matchup is that these kids all know each other from years and years of playing those weekend tournaments that these parents have to drag all their kids to, and you saw that. That's why there was sportsmanship on the floor. Like, these guys have played against each other in many different gyms all over the place, and this time they get to do it in the varsity, wearing their school jersey on their chest. And so, of course, it's a little more intense, and it's a little more interesting. But, yeah, they've played a lot of basketball against each other, which means they know each other's strengths, they know each other's weaknesses, and, boy, you can really see them taking advantage of those things during the game. You go way back to the beginning of the game, Tyler. It started off even the whole way, but a difference maker in the first half was Fothergill.
Yes.
He went on a stretch there where, unlike we've seen many high schoolers do, where he was just on fire, and that was pretty fun to see. And then in the second half, it flipped back the other way, and he went a little bit cold. And I kept waiting for Fothergill to take over the game again, but North Union, they had to use the whole team, and I didn't see Gerdet much offensively the whole game. He'd missed a few shots earlier, and when he hit that shot at the end, I couldn't believe it that he sunk that, swished it. That's just one of those moments in high school sports that are fun, and you and I can never recreate that. It was a moment to see, and this whole gym leapt up on this side of the floor. Garrigan's had plenty of those moments too in this gym, but that was an exciting high school basketball moment right there.
Well, there was a lot of pressure on North Union tonight. Whether they admit that or not, that's on them, but there was a ton of pressure on North Union tonight because Warriors and Lake Mills, they are tied in the loss column of one loss apiece. Of course, that Lake Mills one loss was against North Union, but in theory, if North Union loses tonight, that's their second loss, and then you don't expect Lake Mills to lose two conference games. Even if North Union beats Lake Mills at the end of the season, then you say, well, we're settling for a split of the conference. With this, North Union keeps an outright conference title a possibility because they do play Lake Mills again in early February. So, mm-hmm. You know, right now this is a Warrior team that's trying for that first Top of Iowa West title against a Lake Mills team that's really kind of dominated this conference for the past couple of years, and they keep themselves in a position to do that for the win tonight.
Yeah, Lake Mills has been at the top of the conference for what seems like forever. And, if I'm sure wherever Lake Mills is playing tonight, if they're wrapping up their game, they're tuning into us right now to see if Garrigan was able to pull off a win against North Union, because they were Garrigan's biggest fans tonight, because that would have gave them in the driver's seat. But no, North Union pulls it off. So there's a tie at the top of the conference, and then there's a big mess right in the middle of the conference of everyone scrapping out to see who's going to emerge out of the middle.
Well, second heartbreaking loss this week for Garrigan, who gave up the go-ahead bucket to Garner Haven Ventura on Tuesday with about 4 seconds left in that game. And today against North Union, give up a bucket with 3 seconds left to Preston Gerdet on the three-point ball. But, you know, Beanie, losses are built differently. That Tuesday loss against Garner Haven Ventura left a really sour taste in the Golden Bears' mouth. And tonight will as well, but for kind of a different reason. You know, you looked at a North Union team that had a superior record going into the game and one that had the motivation factor of losing the first time around. You know, this is going to be a loss that feels a bit different for Garrigan than the game against Garner on Tuesday, just because, you know, the quality of the opponent was really escalated tonight.
Oh, for sure. And there's a lot of gamers on that Garrigan team that really get up for big games. And they're going to go back and look at this and think, well, what could we have done differently? And I'm not so sure this is one of those games where it's something that you could have done differently or anything. You got a lot of good play out of a lot of your players. It was a great high school contest. It just came up a little bit short there. And that's the way the cookie crumbles sometimes.
Well, a couple of great games tonight as Bishop Garrigan wins the girls' game, but North Union wins the boys' game, and that'll wrap it up for our broadcast tonight. For my partner, Beanie Bodie, I'm Tyler Lance, signing off as, once again, your final score, North Union 53 and Bishop Garrigan 50. This has been a sports production of Hometown Radio KLGA.